माया मनुष्यं हरिं वन्देहं करुणाकरं रघुवरं भूपाल चूड़ामणिं नान्या स्प्रहा रघुपते हृदये स्मदीये सत्यं वदामि च भवान् खिलांतरात्मा भक्तिं प्रयच्छ रघुपुंगव निर्भरां मे कामादि दोष रहितं कुरु मानसं च अतुलित बलधाम
प्रैक्टिस कर लेती हूँ
हेम शैला
खड़ा
हम धनुज
अ वेरी गुड मॉर्निंग टू वन एंड ऑल प्रेजेंट हियर आई इशिका गर्ग थर्ड ईयर स्टूडेंट ऑफ बीएससी इंडस्ट्रियल केमिस्ट्री देशबंधु कॉलेज
आई मनदीप कौर थर्ड ईयर स्टूडेंट ऑफ बीएससी केमिस्ट्री ऑनर्स देशबंधु कॉलेज एक्सटेंड अ वार्म वेलकम टू आवर चीफ गेस्ट सर प्रोफेसर राकेश कुमार पराशर डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ केमिस्ट्री यूनिवर्सिटी ऑफ दिल्ली गेस्ट ऑफ ऑनर सर प्रोफेसर अनिल कुमार हेड ऑफ डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ अप्लाइड केमिस्ट्री दिल्ली टेक्नोलॉजिकल यूनिवर्सिटी ऑनरेबल सर प्रोफेसर राजेंद्र कुमार पांडे प्रिंसिपल देशबंधु कॉलेज सर डॉक्टर आदित्य सक्सेना
मुझे लगा उधर तुम पूछ रही हो यार किसी को
जब लग आवो सीत ही देखी होय हिकाज मोहि हर्ष
बसेसी
यह कहनाई सब ही कहु माता चले उहर सिंहिया
क्योंकि वो इसके लगाए हुए हैं ठीक है और मेरे को पता है मैंने अभी तुम्हें समझा रही हूँ मैं माइक पे आती ना मेरी तुमसे ज्यादा डबल स्पीड हो जाएगी और मेरे साथ ऐसा होता है
रवीना थोड़ा लगता ही है
अब देख ये शिफ्ट करने में आवाज
कृष्ण गजानन जिन चरणों को सेवते ते सूर्य ब्रह्म शिव विष्णु गजानन जिन चरणों को सेवते हम शिशु है अज्ञानी माता इन चरणों का प्यार दे वंदन ध्यान को मूरख हम नहीं जाने जननी पूजन वंदन ध्यान को आदि शक्ति कर क्षमा में आदि शक्ति कर क्षमा में पूजा के उदयकार दे
एक सेकंड रुक जाओ यार,
स्टार्ट है।
बोलो।
हेलो हेलो,
इसी से स्टार्ट कर देंगे।
एक सेकंड रुक जाओ ना, अभी पहले स्टार्ट करना है।
हम बोल रहे हैं सर, स्टार्ट कर दो। सर से पूछ ले एक बार।
वक्रतुंड महाकाय सूर्यकोटि समप्रभा, निर्विघ्नं कुरु मे देव सर्वकार्येषु सर्वदा।
A very good morning to one and all present here. I, Ishika Garg, third year student of BSc Industrial Chemistry, Deshbandhu College.
I, Mandeep Kaur, third year student of BSc Chemistry Honours, Deshbandhu College, extend a warm welcome to our chief guest, Sir Professor Rakesh Kumar Parashar, Department of Chemistry, University of Delhi, guest of honour, Sir Professor Anil Kumar, Head of Department of Applied Chemistry, Delhi Technological University, Honorable Sir Professor Rajendra Kumar Pandey, Principal, Deshbandhu College, Sir Dr. Aditya Saxena, Coordinator IQAC, Sir Dr. Vivek Saxena, the Senior Most Faculty Member, Department of Chemistry, Sir Professor Mahesh Chand, Teacher in Charge, and Ma'am Professor Namita Gandhi, Convener, Resonance.
This fest is not just an event, it's a celebration of the beauty and significance of chemistry in our lives. It's a platform where passion meets knowledge and curiosity fuels innovation. Throughout this fest, we aim to ignite the spark of scientific inquiry and a deeper appreciation for the wonders of chemistry among all participants, be it students, educators, or enthusiasts. Now, I would request our chief guests, dignitaries, and senior faculty members present on the dais for lamp lighting and worship ceremony.
As light destroys darkness, in the same way, knowledge destroys ignorance. We bow down to fill our lives with the light of knowledge and compassion. I request our chemical society to please give their tremendous tribute to Ma Saraswati by Vandana. I request all of you to please stand up for Pulgi.
Jai जयति जय जय जयति जय जय ज्ञान का लोक अनुपम
श्रेष्ठ सुंदर दिव्य दिल्ली विश्वविद्यालय विहंगम
जयति जय जय जयति जय जय ज्ञान का लोक अनुपम सकल वसुधा निज कुटुंब की भावना संस्कृति सनातन आधुनिक शिक्षा पुरातन ज्ञान धाराओं का संगम
देश की स्वाधीनता हित भूमि का शत कोटि वंदन
निष्ठा धृति सत्यम के मंगल दिव्य भावों का समागम
जयति जय जय जयति जय जय ज्ञान का आलोक
भव्य महाविद्यालयों के परिसरों से चिर सुशोभित श्रेष्ठ गुरुजन कर रहे छात्र और छात्राएं दीक्षित
सदचरित्राचार पावन साधना संकल्प संयम
नवल वैश्विक चेतना नव क्रांति संस्कारों का उद्गम जयति जय जय जयति जय जय ज्ञान का लोक अनुपम
श्रेष्ठ सुंदर दिव्य दिल्ली विश्वविद्यालय विहंगम
जयति जय जय जयति जय जय ज्ञान का आलोक अनुपम
ज्ञान का आलोक अनुपम
ज्ञान का आलोक अनुपम
ज्ञान का आलोक अनुपम
Sapling is the purest and most genuine offering. It also represents the beginning of life. So, I would like to cordially invite our Honorable Principal Sir, Professor Rajendra Kumar Pandey, and Teacher in Charge, Sir Professor Mahesh Chandra, to felicitate our Chief Guest, Sir Professor Rakesh Kumar Parashar, Professor in Department of Chemistry and Chairman Governing Body, Shivaji College with the Sapling and Angvastra. Now, I request IQAC coordinators Sir Dr. Aditya Saxena and Dr. Gajendra Sir to present the sapling and angvastra to our guest of honor, Sir Professor Anil Kumar, Head of Department of Applied Chemistry, Delhi Technological University. Now I request Ma'am Professor Sushila Singhal and Convener Ma'am Professor Namita Gandhi and Parush Agarwal, President of Chemical Society, to felicitate our Principal Sir.
Now, I request Dr. Umesh Sir and Vice President of Chemical Society Ekta Bhargav to present the sapling and angvastra to IQAC Coordinator Sir Dr. Aditya Saxena. I would request Dr. Maku sir and Secretary of Chemical Society Sandeep to felicitate the senior most faculty sir Dr. Vivek Saxena. Now I invite Dr. Rohit sir and Treasurer of Chemical Society Manish Chaudhary to present the sapling and angvastra to Teacher in Charge sir Professor Mahesh Chand. I request ma'am Dr. Parul Singh and Media Head of Chemical Society Anjali Sharma to present the sapling and angvastra to ma'am Professor Namita Gandhi.
Now I request our principal sir to bless us all with his words of wisdom.
Thank you so much. Respected Professor Rakesh Kumar Parasar sir. Chief guest for this program, Professor Anil Kumar ji, guest of honor, Professor Vivek Saxena sir, Professor Namita Gandhi ji, Professor Mahesh ji, Professor Aditya Saxena ji, my friends, colleagues and dear students. In the opening remarks of these two girls, they said that they have assembled here to celebrate the festival of chemistry. The usage of this term is itself a stunning idea which must be cherished and imbibed by all of us. Though my area of interest is political science, but when you ask me to speak in the function of chemistry people, just imagine what should I speak and what I can speak. But when they say that this is the celebration of chemistry, it means that chemistry has very close relationship not only with the things which you people focus in your academic research and teaching, but also the normal ways of life. We assemble here annually, in fact biannually, Mahesh, we assemble biannually to celebrate this festival of chemistry in the name of resonance. And this celebration must not be confined only to the students of chemistry, but should also go to the people of other streams. In fact, two very interesting insights Professor Parashar and I were discussing, that in such events where public at large gather to listen to the eminent scientists, researchers, then the things on which they do research, they develop their ideas, need not be discussed. research and your creative ideas are meant to be published, not to be discussed in such popular lectures and gatherings. But when we talk about popularity of chemistry as a subject, what comes to our mind is the idea that in such gatherings, we should try for a blending of both the common parlances about the subject and how can we attune it to fit to the needs of the Department of Chemistry, which has organized this function. I'm sure that this two-day event of the chemistry department would be very meaningful and impactful for all the participants in this program. Though I'm amazed to look at the number of people who have assembled here for the function. I think chemistry department itself has a large number of students. And this hall should be insufficient for the department to house all of them. But the number which we are seeing here, in my opinion, is very less. And such events are, since very crucial, very important, and much awaited ones, so it must be our endeavor to involve as many students, as many faculty members, and as many other audiences also as possible. I extend my best wishes to the organizers of this event, Professor Mahesh Meena ji, Professor Namita Gandhi ji, and all the chemistry people, and also students, that in these 2 days, you people will be able to discuss the important ideas of chemistry and arrive at some tangible conclusions which will help you transform your life. Thank you so much.
Thank you, sir. Foraging ahead, I invite our teacher in charge, Sir Professor Mahesh Chand, to welcome our chief guest and address the gathering.
Good morning. Namaskar. Respected two-day chief guest, Professor Rakesh Parasa sir, Professor Anil Kumar sir, Principal Professor Rajendra Kumar Pandey sir, IQSC Coordinator Dr. Aditya Saxena sir, our department senior faculties Dr. Vivek Saxena sir, and Resonance or a Chemical Society convener, Professor Namita Gandhi, all the esteemed colleagues and my dear friends, on behalf of Chemical Society and Department of Chemistry, I welcome to all here. It's my pleasure to welcome everyone to our this bright national seminar cum resonance 2024. We are honored to have such a great personality among us. We are the honor to have such great personality among us, Professor Rakesh Prasar sir and Professor Anil Kumar sir. It is really a pleasant opportunity to all of us, for here is word of wisdom. Thank you sir for accepting our invitation and give the valuable time for us. I also thanks to Principal Sir for constant support, encouragement throughout its events. It also thanks Chemical Societies, Office Bearers, and our department, all staff, teaching and non-teaching staff, also will be helpful for the organize this event. So I'm grateful thanks to all. I request to all students to maintain the decorum and discipline throughout the events or your program for 2 days with and enjoy the moment of resonance and seminar. With these words, once again, I welcome to all of enjoy every moment of seminar and resonance fest. Thanks to all of you.
Thank you, sir, for raging ahead. I invite Rohit sir to please introduce our chief guest, Sir Professor Rakesh Kumar Parashar, Department of Chemistry, University of Delhi.
Good morning, one and all. It gives me immense pleasure to introduce today's chief guest, Professor Rakesh Kumar Parashar from Department of Chemistry, University of Delhi. Sir has very illustrious career. Sir did his PhD under Professor V.K. Ahluwalia at University of Delhi in 1990. After completing his PhD, he joined Crodimal College as a lecturer. During his tenure at Crodimal College, Sir went for a postdoctorate in 1996 at the University of Barcelona, Spain, and did another postdoctorate from the University of New Lisbon, Portugal. After teaching for more than 2 decades at Crodimal College, Sir joined the Department of Chemistry, University of Delhi, as an associate professor in 2015. Currently, he is a professor in the Department of Chemistry. There are many feathers in his cap. Sir is also chairman governing body at Shivaji College, University of Delhi. Sir has a long list of research papers in national and international journals of repute. There are 9 books in his credit. One of the famous books, which is very popular among students, is Organic Reaction Mechanisms. It is my profound privilege to invite Professor Parashar for his talk. Welcome you, sir.
Doesn't matter. All right. पर आप खोल दीजिएगा वेल आई फील ऑनर्ड टू बी पार्ट ऑफ Chemistry Department Function Resonance 2024. So Deshbandhu College Chemistry Department faculty, very very talented and they are so hard working. I can witness because I am directly associated with all the faculty members of, I can name all, the not the younger one, but today onward, and I will remember the names also, and I will keep on pricking you. Ye paper bana dijiye, ye practical lene jaiyega. But I feel honored to be here, leaving so many other assignments simultaneously going on. Whenever there is a invitation from college, since I belong to Crorimal College, I started my career from college. So I feel at home in college and in any DU college. The faces sitting here, the young, enthusiastic students. So whenever I get the opportunity to interact with you all, so I feel so young, no? So mujhe wo din yaad aate hain, the very first lecture I took in Crorimal College. And before that, I was so nervous. I was in Mansarovar Hostel. Darwaja tha aise, uski back pe main chalk se likh ke pura lecture gaya tha. Ki bache question puchhenge, kaise hoga, kya hoga. So I was so nervous. तब क्वेश्चन पूछते नहीं थे, डरे होते थे स्टूडेंट, पर्टिकुलरली दिस आई स्टूडेंट. मैं हमेशा कहता हूं, नाउ द थिंग्स हैव चेंज्ड, सिलेबस भी चेंज हुआ है. एक स्किल, कम्युनिकेशन स्किल की कमी थी हम सब में. वी हैव पिक्ड अप, वी हैव डन ए सो मच हार्ड वर्क टू पिक अप दैट, बट नाउएडेज सिलेबस हैज बीन चेंज्ड, इट इज पार्ट ऑफ योर सिलेबस नाउ, स्किल एनहांसमेंट. और दूसरा ये था कि पता नहीं क्या फोबिया था, साइंस स्टूडेंट्स टीचर से बात करते हुए थोड़ा सा घबराते थे. तब मार्क्स भी ज्यादा होते थे प्रैक्टिकल्स में, कि मार्क्स अच्छे मिल जाए तो क्लास में कोई गलत क्वेश्चन ना पूछ ले. बट गलत टाइम था वो, हमने बहुत सफर किया. द थिंग्स हैव बीन चेंज्ड, यू आर वेरी लकी टू गेट, you are getting this opportunity. I will, the very first thing I will tell you, chemistry samajh aa jayegi, subject samajh aa jayega, pass bhi ho jaoge. But ye jo training hai aapki, jo aap interact karenge teachers ke saath directly, ye aapko bahut long tak pay karega. Aap mein ye confidence jo hai, if you want to have not only chemistry, any career in life. So, ये जो अंडर, ये जो ग्रेजुएशन पीरियड, अब तो चार साल है, दीज फोर ईयर यू विल रिमेंबर वेर एवर यू विल गो इन वर्ल्ड, वेर एवर यू विल गो. तो इसको आपको अच्छी तरह से जीना है. इसके बाद आप एमएससी करें, आई विल शो यू दिस स्लाइड, हो गया. तो थैंक यू वेरी मच the organizers for your kind invitation and giving me this opportunity to interact with the young students and faculty members. Maine jo aaj talk hai, abhi 4-5 talks ikatthi hui hai. I was in Crorimal College few days back, then RK Mangalam University mein abhi ek lecture tha on 15th. So there was a conference. So I was talking about my research work, what we are doing in laboratory. So that is not of your level, ki main us research, but I will show you few slides. Samajh aati hai, theek hai. Aur agar 1% bhi usme se samajh aati hai, I won't spend much time there, but it will be a very general talk. And you can ask me many questions, you can stop me in between as well. Since I was the in charge of placement cell in Delhi University, CPC, Central Placement Cell, so I used to call several companies. So, aap log register karte hain, aate hain, to main sare student ko watch karta tha, apni Delhi University ke student ko watch karta tha, ki kaise interact karte hain. कैसे ग्रुप डिस्कशन करते हैं, सीवी कैसे लिखते हैं, इंटरव्यू कैसे देते हैं, हाउ कॉन्फिडेंट आर यू, क्या हमारे दिल्ली यूनिवर्सिटी में मोर देन 70 कॉलेजेस हैं, कुछ लोगों ने तो ग्रेडिंग की है, ए क्लास बी क्लास, स्टीफन कॉलेज बहुत अच्छा है, हिंदू कॉलेज बहुत अच्छा है, आप लोग भी सोचते होंगे कि हिंदू कॉलेज में एडमिशन मिल जाता, फैकल्टी सेम है, जिसने पीएचडी की वैकेंसी निकली जो जिस कॉलेज में गया वो वहां एब्जॉर्ब हो गया, ऐसा कुछ नहीं है कि हिंदू कॉलेज में अलग फैकल्टी है और देशबंधु कॉलेज में या केएम में अलग है, सो फैकल्टी इज सेम, सिलेबस इज सेम, एवरीथिंग इज सेम, सो इट इज अप टू यू. आई विल गिव यू वेरी सिंपल लिटल इंसिडेंट व्हाट हैज हैपेंड. एक जैपनीज कंपनी आई हमारे पास, उन्होंने सर्वे वहां बैठ के उन्होंने एक सर्वे किया कि किस तरह के कॉलेजेस हैं, तो उन्होंने कहा कि पराशर, डॉक्टर पराशर, वी वांट द स्टूडेंट फ्रॉम दीज कॉलेजेस. उसमें लिस्ट थी हिंदू कॉलेज, हंसराज कॉलेज और शायद मिरांडा हाउस, फ्रॉम दीज कॉलेजेस. वी सेड नो, वी वांट डिस्क्लोज यू द नेम ऑफ द कॉलेज, यू टेक द इंटरव्यू ऑफ द कैंडिडेट. सरप्राइजिंगली they took four and all of them were from not from the campus colleges, all the four they have taken. So you should be encouraged by listening all these things. And sabse pehle main kehta hu ki agar aapko chemistry career karna hai, rakhna hai, to aap thoda sa uske bare mein janiye. जैसे आज का लेक्चर है, और भी लोग लेक्चर देंगे, और अगर नहीं भी करना तो भी आप समझिएगा, वो कहीं ना कहीं पे आपका जरूर यूज होगा, आपका इट विल नेवर गो इन वेन. सो लिटिल थिंग्स, अभी ये नहीं है तो मैं अभी स्टार्ट नहीं कर रहा हूं, तो मैं आपको थोड़ा सा सीपीसी के बारे में ही बता दूं कि गलती कहां करते हैं बच्चे. इवन सीवी नहीं लिखना आता, यू शुड नो हाउ टू राइट दिस सीवी. एक कंपनी आती है और वो सिर्फ कहती है कि ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ सीवी फर्स्ट शॉर्ट लिस्टिंग विल बी डन. अच्छा, ओके, सो आई विल टेक अप दिस पार्ट अ लिटल लेटर. आई विल कम टू दिस पार्ट, हाउ टू राइट सीवी, हाउ टू फेस द इंटरव्यू, बट टूडे आई विल बी टॉकिंग अबाउट इन जनरल chemistry a promising career. I will give you something about chemistry ki jinka man nahi kar raha tha chemistry padhne ka bhi, shayad aaj wo thoda sa change zarur hoga, aisa main soch raha hu after listening my talk. Next, career, all the time people are, student are thinking about career, so let's talk about this chemistry as career. Next, keep on changing. So chemistry is everywhere. You are lucky. I feel proud to be a student of chemistry or teacher of the chemistry. Everywhere, the morning you get up till you go to bed, you are dealing with chemistry. Need not to say. Next. So what to do after graduation? Aapke man mein aata hai. After graduation, what next? Employment, will you go for employment directly? कुछ बच्चों का, कुछ parents, कुछ families नहीं उनको चाहिए, immediate job चाहिए. Fair enough, there are jobs, we will talk about that. Further studies, postgraduate, you want some time out, want to think about something else, कुछ business करना है, डिसीजन नहीं लिया, डजंट मैटर, एक साल टाइम आउट और समथिंग एल्स, वी विल टॉक अबाउट दिस. नेक्स्ट, कीप ऑन चेंजिंग प्लीज, एक जना बैठ जाओ. लेट मी टेल यू, ग्रेजुएशन इज नॉट द एंड, इट इज द बिगिनिंग इन केमिस्ट्री. नेक्स्ट, सो गवर्नमेंट अनफॉर्चुनेटली आफ्टर डूइंग ग्रेजुएशन बी एस सी इन केमिस्ट्री, देर आर नॉट सेवरल जॉब्स स्पेसिफिक टू केमिस्ट्री स्टूडेंट. यस, यू कैन अप्लाई इन ऑल दोज जॉब्स जो कि एक सिंपल ग्रेजुएट के लिए है, एसएससी के थ्रू है, जो भी आपकी निकलती हैं, वो आप एक कंपटीशन इंटरव्यू जो भी है उसके थ्रू आप लेंगे, और वो एक बीकॉम वाला, इकोनॉमिक्स वाला, हिंदी वाला, इंग्लिश वाला, वो भी उन्हीं जॉब्स के लिए अप्लाई करेगा. यू हैव टू कम्पीट विद दैट. सो कीपिंग केमिस्ट्री इन माइंड, देर आर प्राइवेट कंपनीज, फार्मास्यूटिकल कंपनी, एग्रीकल्चर बेस्ड कंपनी, फाइन केमिकल्स, यू कैन ज्वाइन, बट देर इज नो ग्रोथ. लेटर ऑन यू विल रियलाइज, नहीं अब पढ़ लेते कॉन्टिन्यूएशन में तो स्टेग्नेशन नहीं होगी, आगे पढ़ना चाहिए आपको नेक्स्ट. सो देर आर फाइव ट्रेडिशनल एरिया ऑफ स्टडी इफ यू वॉन्ट टू डू पोस्ट ग्रेजुएशन: ऑर्गेनिक, इनऑर्गेनिक, बायोकेमिस्ट्री, एनालिटिकल केमिस्ट्री, फिजिकल केमिस्ट्री. बट नाउडेज देर इज ए नैनो केमिस्ट्री एज वेल. जो भी पीएचडी करने आते हैं हमारे पास स्टूडेंट, 10 में से अगर इंटरव्यू लेते हैं, 8 कहते हैं हमें नैनो टेक्नोलॉजी में करनी है, नैनो केमिस्ट्री में करनी है पीएचडी. इसको थोड़ा सा समझ लीजिए कि नैनो टेक्नोलॉजी, नैनो केमिस्ट्री बहुत वास्ट है, बहुत वास्ट है. एग्जैक्टली उसमें आपने कहाँ जाना है, और मटेरियल साइंस में जाना है, फेयर इनफ, बहुत अच्छा. आज की डेट में बहुत अच्छा इसका स्कोप है. नेक्स्ट, सो बट ये जो मैंने दिखाया है, एनालिटिकल, ऑर्गेनिक, इनऑर्गेनिक, फिजिकल, यही पढ़ते हैं हम लोग, अ लिटिल बिट नैनो टेक्नोलॉजी नॉ. बट केमिस्ट्री इज नॉट द जॉब्स एंड एरिया, पोस्ट ग्रेजुएशन इज नॉट ओनली ऑफ फाइव और सिक्स फील्ड. नहीं, वापस उसको. सो देर आर सो मेनी इंडस्ट्रीज वेयर यू कैन गो: पॉलीमर केमिस्ट्री, पल्प एंड पेपर, R&D, मैनेजमेंट, साइंस राइटिंग, टेक्सटाइल केमिस्ट्री, वाटर केमिस्ट्री, मटेरियल साइंस. फ्रॉम माई एक्सपीरियंस, केमिस्ट्री स्टूडेंट पेटेंट के लिए जाते हैं, लॉ फर्म्स ज्वाइन करते हैं, वैकेंसीज निकलती हैं, आप लॉ फर्म्स को भी अप्रोच कर सकते हैं. सो दैट इज नॉट, दीज आर दी इंडस्ट्रीज रिलेटेड टू, आई मीन वेरियस टॉपिक्स: केमिकल टेक्नोलॉजी, केमिकल सेल, केमिकल इंफॉर्मेशन, फोरेंसिक साइंस. सो वेयर यू कैन अप्लाई फॉर जॉब आफ्टर ग्रेजुएशन और पोस्ट ग्रेजुएशन. नेक्स्ट, सो देर आर, इफ यू आर गोइंग फॉर MSc, देन ऑफकोर्स यू विल बी अपेयरिंग फॉर नेट एग्जाम, एंड देन यू विल बी डूइंग PhD. So from where you will be doing PhD, there are several institutes like National Chemical Laboratory, Pune is very good. Even when you are doing BSc, when you will be in third year or fourth year, you start writing them. Wo internship program karte hain, ye NCL Pune, ICER, National Institute of Chemical Technology, Hyderabad, IIS, Indian Institute of Science, Bangalore, they pay something, आपका वो खर्चा निकल जाता है. इंटर्नशिप, एक रिटर्न एग्जाम होता है जहां उनकी इंटरव्यू होती है, इफ यू क्वालिफाई दे टेक यू, दैट विल गिव ए लॉट ऑफ एक्सपोजर टू यू पीपल ज्वाइनिंग ए वेरी प्रेस्टिजियस इंस्टीट्यूट रिलेटेड विद द केमिस्ट्री. सो ICERs आर देयर, NIPERs आर देयर. So these are different from universities. These are the research institute mainly, and they are doing good research. But nevertheless, Delhi University Chemistry Department is very good for research. You are all are most welcome after your MSc to do PhD in Delhi University. We are waiting for you to come get a degree of doctorate. Next, from Delhi University. Next, but where after doing PhD, then what? Lecturership in colleges. Delhi University, क्योंकि बहुत बड़े हैं, colleges are statutory body, not affiliated. Delhi University के साथ है, बहुत सारी vacancies निकलती हैं. तो one option is lecturership, but that is not the only one. उसके साथ साथ रिसर्च करते रहिएगा. आपकी फैकल्टी मेंबर्स मुझे पता है बहुत सारे लोग रिसर्च करते हैं. यू कैन सी द इंटायर वर्ल्ड. डू द केमिस्ट्री. केमिस्ट्री चूज केमिस्ट्री एज एन कैरियर एंड देन यू रोम अराउंड वर्ल्ड. मीट सेवरल पीपल नॉट फ्रॉम योर पॉकेट. गवर्नमेंट विल पे. यूनिवर्सिटी विल पे. इंस्टीट्यूट विल पे. दिस इज द बिगेस्ट एडवांटेज ऑफ डूइंग रिसर्च. यू रोम अराउंड वर्ल्ड. सी द वर्ल्ड. मीट वेरियस पीपल. एक्सचेंज योर आइडियाज. वो हो ही जाएगा. एक्सचेंज योर आइडियाज. नेक्स्ट. सो बट देर इज नो लिमिट. यू कैन गो अप टू यू कैन गेट एप्रिसिएशन एंड गो फॉर थिंक अबाउट द हाइएस्ट अवार्ड नोबेल प्राइज. मैंने इसको लिया है नोबेल प्राइज वाले स्लाइड को जानबूझ के लिया है. आप सबको पता है नोबेल प्राइज क्या है. इसके बारे में बहुत ज्यादा नहीं बोलूंगा क्योंकि अभी अभी हाल में ही 2-3 साल पहले कुछ साइंटिस्ट को नोबेल प्राइज मिला है क्लिक रिएक्शन के लिए. आई विल बी गोइंग टू एक्सप्लेन यू दैट. अगेन आई विल कम बैक टू दिस फैकल्टी के लिए भी और स्टूडेंट के लिए भी कि हम लोग क्या सोचते हैं इंडिया में रह के और जो बाहर है रिसर्च करते हैं वो क्या सोचते हैं. रिसर्च हम भी उसी तरीके से करते हैं. हमारे में भी कैलिबर है लेकिन एक कॉन्फिडेंस नहीं है कि हम उस लेवल पे जा सकते हैं. विद फ्यू 2-3 slides आई विल एक्सप्लेन माय पॉइंट. नेक्स्ट. आपको पता है कि ओरिजिनली 5 फील्ड में नोबेल प्राइज मिलता था. इकोनॉमिक्स में लास्ट में इंट्रोड्यूस हुआ है. पीस इज द ओनली नॉर्वे गिव्स. ऑल अदर नोबेल प्राइजेस आर गिवन बाय स्वीडन. नेक्स्ट. एंड नेक्स्ट नेक्स्ट नेक्स्ट. सो दीज आर द पीपल हु गॉट द नोबेल प्राइज फ्रॉम इंडिया एंड अब्रॉड. द वेंकटरमन रामाकृष्णन गॉट द नोबेल प्राइज इज इंडियन ओरिजिन. And ribosome, chemistry, botany, biology, research level के बाद सब अलग अलग नहीं हो जाती, सब इकट्ठी हो जाती हैं. Next, एक चीज बोलनी है आपको. आप chemistry कर रहे हैं, research आप biochemistry में, botany में, zoology में, geology में, किसी में भी कर सकते हैं. And it is not the other way around. जो chemistry में हम आपको पढ़ाते हैं वो बायोकेमिस्ट्री वाला नहीं समझ सकता. आप बायोकेमिस्ट्री सारी समझ सकते हैं. दैट इज द एडवांटेज ऑफ टेकिंग केमिस्ट्री और डूइंग रिसर्च इन केमिस्ट्री. नेक्स्ट. अच्छा, आई वाज टॉकिंग अबाउट द नोबेल प्राइज फ्यू इयर्स बैक, कपल ऑफ इयर्स बैक. द साइंटिस्ट हु गॉट द नोबेल प्राइज फॉर क्लिक केमिस्ट्री इज द शार्पलेस. ही गॉट द नोबेल प्राइज ट्वाइस. Second time he got this Nobel Prize. First time he got for epoxidation, asymmetric synthesis. He is the only living scientist who got the Nobel Prize in chemistry twice. So, पहले भी 2-3 लोगों को मिल चुका है, but they are no more. He is the living scientist. Next, and here I have shown he got earlier also in 2001. Next. So, he got the Nobel Prize for click reaction. Very simple reaction. Azide group and alkyne. So, you need to couple them. It's a coupling reaction. Azide and alkyne in presence of a catalyst, copper one, and triazole is synthesized. Triazole is formed. Very simple reaction. What does this mean? Click. Click means click. It happens very fast. Regioselective. Regioisomers hote hain. I will explain. Regioisomer means
this is number one. If you start the numbering of heterocyclic ring, so you have to start the numbering from nitrogen and go in such a direction so that the least number should be given to other heteroatoms. So I won't go this way. 1, 2, 3, 4. So this is 1/4 product, isn't it? We may get 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So this is the isomer, and I will call this regioisomer. But this reaction is so beautifully done that you get 100% only one regioisomer, regioselective. That's why I am saying regioselective. Next. So this reaction is very known earlier also, but you used to get mixture 1,4 and 1,5. The click reaction hai jo copper 1 ki presence mein hota hai, and we get 1,4 isomer only when we use copper. Next. But why we get only 1,4? And when we use ruthenium, I have used ruthenium catalyst, and here we get 1,5 product. 1,5 product, regioisomer. So it is the basically, you can see, jaise Heck reaction hai, carbon-carbon coupling in presence of transition metal. All right, palladium. Palladium catalyzed, I will say, carbon-carbon coupling reaction. Three scientists got the Nobel Prize for this work: Heck, Negashi, and Suzuki. Isn't it? Carbon-carbon coupling. They use different starting material and different catalyst. But basic mechanism is same. The metal is in low oxidation state. Oxidative addition is the first step. Then coordination of metal with carbon takes place. In when it is copper, the coordination is a little different, one side, and when it is ruthenium, it is in center and it goes other way. So that is why you get the different stereo regioisomer. So if you go into the detail, the last is beta elimination. These are the three steps mainly. This is in cycle because your catalyst is back and your compound is coming out. Okay, next. So this is the person, Sharpless, who has given this, and he got the Nobel Prize. So I will consider this reaction as a green reaction, as a green chemistry reaction, isn't it? But it is not part of those 12 principles. You know, in green chemistry, there are 12 principles. So why it is not part of click reaction, is not part of green principles? Because it was discovered later on. Anatas and Warner gave it earlier, and after in 1995, and 2001 the click reaction came. My question is ki 2001 se ye reaction aayi hai, itne logon ne is reaction ko use kiya hai. I will show, and ultimately they got the Nobel Prize for this work. Why they have not brought it in the green, why the green principles, 12 principles have not been changed? Why we are not taking out the ionic liquid from there? Because it is no more green solvent. It's very expensive. It's toxic also. So someone, the youngster, there is a lot to do. Two or three faculty members can sit with student and redraft it and publish a paper. Okay, this is what we think, isn't it? This has to be changed. Very simple work. You can involve the student and let's do. I expect someone to do it. Prativa green chemistry mein karti hai. Why not? Very simple thing. So suggest, give points in favor, give points against the ionic liquid. Change those 12 principles. Rewrite them. Write one review. It will be published in a very good journal. Next. So here I would like to mention. First, I will show you how they got the Nobel Prize for this reaction. Click reaction hua, triazole bana. Triazole, what is the use of triazole? We use triazole as a linker. Why we use it as a linker? Because it imparts the rigidity to the molecule, overall molecule. It has three nitrogens. It is polar. Ultimately, when it is inside the body, it will interact with the amino acids or proteins. There are so many hydrogen bonding, and it stabilizes the system. All right.
So that is why it is triazoles are very important drug molecules, as a drug molecules also. But here they have used this click reaction as a chemosensor, isn't it? Inside the cell. Glycan are the sugars. We can convert one OH of glycan. If you consider glucose, six membered ring, oxygen, next is carbon, OH. OH can be replaced to N3. So they have replaced glycan inside the cell, inside the tissue, they have replaced glycan OH with N3. So one part is there. So then they have introduced alkyne, eight-membered ring, alkyne, and one fluorescent green molecule is already linked with that. All right, they did the click reaction inside the cell, very simple, and they got this green fluorescence. Confocal microscope se hum dekh sakte hain. Fluorescence, or bhi, there are so many other ways, switch on, switch off. Fluorescence jo absorption peak hai, if you remember Jablonski diagram, fluorescence hai, wo quench ho jati hai aur enhance ho jati hai jab uski jo peak hai shift ho jati hai, but confocal microscope se hum dekh sakte hain. So cell mein kya ho raha hai, metabolism kya hai, ye cell kahan pe move ho raha hai, in cancerous cell these cells are moving, how fast they are replicating. So lot of information we can get by doing a simple click reaction. They got the Nobel Prize for this. These are the actual pictures of these cells, fluorescent, you can see. So a biologist must have approached Professor Sharpless ki chaliye is reaction ko cell mein karte hain, click reaction ko, and we will get Nobel Prize. And they got the Nobel Prize for this work. अब मैं यहां पे मैं बहुत बड़ी बात नहीं कर रहा हूं कि ऐसा रिएक्शंस हम अपनी लैब में बरसों से करते आ रहे हैं, चार पांच साल से करते आ रहे हैं. नेक्स्ट आई विल शो यू. सो दीज आर दी केमोसेंसर्स. क्या होते हैं कि एक स्पेसर लगाते हैं और एक पार्ट होता है जहां पे आके मेटल आयन या कोई और मॉलिक्यूल लिंक करता है. सो सम काइंड ऑफ सिग्नल गोज एंड चेंज इन फ्लोरेसेंस सिग्नल भी हो सकता है, नेकेड आई कलरीमेट्रिक भी हो सकता है, चेंज इन फ्लोरेसेंस सिग्नल एज वेल एज नेकेड आई डिटेक्शन बोथ भी हो सकता है. सम ऑप्टिकल चेंजेस टेक्स प्लेस एंड विच यू नोटिस. एंड ये ट्राइजोल इज ओनली द स्पेसर. नेक्स्ट. सो ये केमोसेंसर है. नेक्स्ट. हमने क्या किया, एक कंपाउंड बनाया C1, ग्लूकोज पार्ट लगाया, ये केमोसेंसर बनाया, एंड सरप्राइजिंगली it could detect the iron 3 plus among 20 transition metals. 20 humne transition metal try kiye, usme se selectively isne iron 3 ko detect kiya. And I am proudly say even our chemosensor could differentiate between iron 2 and iron 3. So in water we did. Then we injected this molecule inside the tissue with a collaboration with Ames confocal microscope se humne dekha ki yes it is doing something, it is linking with this, but bahut acha response nahi tha. Later on we realized ki humne do glucose molecule lagaye hain, water soluble permeable nahi hai, wo jo Lipins ki rule aur wo sab laga ke ADME. Next please. So then we replaced, next, ye humne banaya tha, I won't go into detail, next. Then we replaced the sugar molecule with the pyrene ring, lipophilicity badhane ke liye. And then we injected this molecule inside this tissue, next. Injected that molecule inside the tissue under various concentration, you can see, pehle fluorescence ulta bhi ho sakta. Switch off, switch on bhi ho sakta hai, switch off bhi ho sakta hai. You get the signal, no? So you can see under different concentration switch off hua. Wo jo pehle fluorescent tha, wo bilkul blank ho gaya, switch off ho gaya inside the tissue. So it is detecting iron to, or sorry, in this case, copper inside the tissue. So it gives us the fluorescence. देखिए, उन्होंने क्या किया? उन्होंने क्लिक रिएक्शन टिश्यू के अंदर करवाया, सेल के अंदर, और हमने बना के उसको इंजेक्ट किया और अदर अमीनो एसिड और एनी न्यूट्रल मॉलिक्यूल मेटाबोलाइट इन सेल. So we have detected. We can use these chemosensors to detect amino acid and other molecules inside the tissue also. So, मैं सोचा इसके बाद, when he got the Nobel Prize, मैंने अच्छी तरह से उसको पढ़ा. I should have approached, मेरे मन में आता, I should have approached the Sharpless. And I could easily approach Sharpless. Because when I was doing postdoc in Barcelona, he came to my seat and gave me one paper. Because my boss and Sharpless, they were together teachers in Stanford University. तो वो ये सोचने वाली बात है, confidence वाली बात. हम तो कभी सोचते ही नहीं है कि ये हम research इस level की कर सकते हैं या ये भी कर सकते हैं. So, मैं वही सब बच्चों को कहूंगा कि इफ यू वांट कैरियर केमिस्ट्री एज कैरियर, आप सब चीज सोच के चलिएगा. आने वाला टाइम आपका है, आउट ऑफ द बॉक्स जाइए, सब कुछ अचीव कर सकते हैं. इवन द फैकल्टी मेंबर, यंग फैकल्टी मेंबर, यू एक प्लेस आपको मिलनी चाहिए, वर्किंग प्लेस, देन स्काई इज द लिमिट. मैंने कुमार मंगलम यूनिवर्सिटी में ये कहा था कि हमारे पास लेबोरेटरी है, थोड़ी ज्यादा इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर है, आपके पास एनएमआर नहीं है. तो मैं ऐसे क्रोरिमल कॉलेज में था, रिसर्च करके आया था, अच्छी रिसर्च करके आया था बार्सिलोना से, फिर लिस्बन में गया. तो मैं रिसर्च करना चाहता था, एंड आई प्राउडली से आई वाज द फर्स्ट टीचर इन दिल्ली यूनिवर्सिटी हु गॉट द बिग प्रोजेक्ट फ्रॉम डीएसटी इन केमिस्ट्री. When I was in Coronimal College, then I got from DRDO, CSIR, from all the funding agency, I did that. तो मैं करना चाहता था, तो मैं एक लेक्चर सुना प्रोफेसर परमार का, कहीं सुना था मैंने. तो उन्होंने कहा कि बहुत लोग हमें अप्रोच करते हैं कॉलेजेस से और भी यूनिवर्सिटी से, इंडस्ट्री से भी, कि सर हम रिसर्च करेंगे. आते हैं, 5 दिन किया, 10 दिन किया, बोर हो गए, चले गए, फिर नहीं आए, केमिकल वेस्ट हुआ, टाइम वेस्ट हुआ. तो ऐसे चलता नहीं है. देन दे स्टार्टेड रिफ्यूजिंग इट, दे वर नॉट इनकरेजिंग अस. उन्होंने एक लाइन कही, वेयर एवर यू गेट द अपॉर्चुनिटी टू वर्क, जितनी भी फैसिलिटी आपको मिले, आप किसी भी कॉर्नर में बैठे हैं, डू समथिंग फर्स्ट, करके लेके आइए कि सर ये मैंने किया है और ये मैं आगे करना चाह रहा हूं. तो इट विल हैव ए ग्रेटर इंपैक्ट, ऑल द डोर्स आर ओपन फॉर यू ऑल, चाहे स्टूडेंट हो, चाहे फैकल्टी मेंबर हो. डिपार्टमेंट में सारे आप इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर यूज कर सकते हैं. मुझे पता बहुत सारे फैकल्टी मेंबर आर डूइंग वेरी गुड वर्क, आपके स्टूडेंट भी आते हैं इंटरव्यूज में, आपके रिसर्च पब्लिकेशन भी देखते हैं. जो भी फैसिलिटी आपके पास है, बड़े इंस्ट्रूमेंट नहीं है, बट यू आर डूइंग समथिंग, यू आर मोस्ट वेलकम टू हैव ए कोलैबोरेशन विद आईआईटीज, आईसर. बट अपना कुछ करके, एक पेपर चाहे आप ड्राफ्ट करके लीजिए कि ये मैंने काम किया, उसको इम्प्रूव हो सकता है, उसमें और अच्छा काम हो सकता है. सो नेक्स्ट, सो ये मैं कॉन्फिडेंस की बात कर रहा हूं कि ये आउट ऑफ द बॉक्स हमें जाना पड़ेगा. वी हैव एवरीथिंग नाउ. नेक्स्ट प्लीज डू इट फास्ट. सो जैसे मैंने बोला कि स्विच ऑन ऑफ, हम कलरीमेट्रिक भी देख सकते हैं चेंजेस. फॉर एग्जांपल, वन ऑफ माय स्टूडेंट हैज डिटेक्टेड कॉपर एंड AMP2 नेगेटिव कलरीमेट्रिकली. नेक्स्ट I will show you or next. देखिए नहीं, वही वही देखिए, बहुत सारे हमने ट्रांजिशन मेटल लिए, बट when our chemosensor came in contact with copper, there is a change in color. So very good chemosensor. So provided it should do it in nanomolar concentration, है ना? Detection limit हम देखते हैं colorless to pale yellow. Next, So we don't do it only in water. We do it in real sample also. For example, my student detected fluoride in toothpaste. She brought the toothpaste and did it. Hum blood mein bhi dekhte hain. Ye AMP2 minus AMP3, AMP, you know, we could distinguish between AMP1, AMP2 negative, 2, 3 negative, 1 negative inside the body. So metabolism ko samajhne ke liye, these reactions are very important. Next. Now I will be a bit fast. Please, go fast now. Fast. So you may get any color, can be noticed colorimetrically. So these are the chemosensor. Next. Please do it fast. Fast. Skip all these. So we can do it in solid also. Next. So skip all this. So this is my work and I'm skipping it, but I will come to a very interesting story. Let it be. Okay. Hormones, no? The very fascinating stories about chemistry. Ek aur do bataunga main aapko. The hormone industry, बहुत लोगों को नहीं पता कि hormone industry कैसे establish कैसे हुई. It has been established in 1934-35 and it has a very interesting story in Mexico. Mexico में ये hormone industry establish हुई और क्यों हुई and who was the person behind this? उसका दिमाग, मैं वही चीजें ली हैं slide कि आउट ऑफ बॉक्स सोचते हैं जो तो वो अचीव करते हैं आइदर दे गेट नोबेल प्राइज और मनी और इंडस्ट्रियलिस्ट बनते हैं प्रोजेस्टोन नेचुरल किसी एनिमल से एक्सट्रैक्ट करते थे इट इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट हॉर्मोन्स सेक्स हॉर्मोन्स हैं टू स्टे द प्रेगनेंसी आईवीएफ कॉन्सेप्ट वहीं से आया है आईवीएफ जो जाते हैं उनको डॉक्टर एडवाइस करते हैं कि टू टेक लॉट ऑफ प्रोजेस्टोन इन ऑल फॉर्म टेबलेट क्रीम इंजेक्शन सब तरह से स्प्रे सब तरह से देते हैं सो प्रोजेस्टोन बट इट वाज वेरी एक्सपेंसिव अगर आप कोलेस्ट्रॉल के सिंथेसिस देखो रॉबिन्सन 33 स्टेप्स है ओवरऑल यील्ड इज 0.004 इट्स वेरी एक्सपेंसिव अगर लेबोरेटरी में बनाने लगे तो अगर पिग से निकालेंगे तो वी हैव टू किल सो मेनी पिग्स So it was very expensive. Only the very, very rich ladies used to afford it. Baki miscarriages hote the. To ho nahi raha tha. To for example, $80 to 1000 per gram. Ye rate tha at that time, 1935. To next, ek scientist the. Next, Marker Russell. He was working in Pond's laboratory, USA. Next. So he thought that progesterone mujhe synthesize karna hai. Agar main laboratory mein simple molecule se start karke karunga, stereochemistry impart karunga, toh it won't be a viable. Bahut expensive hoga. So he looked at the literature. He was the first person to do the synthesis, such kind of synthesis. Nito Robinson, Corey synthesis, aap dekhiye, badi synthesis hai, Finar mein bari padi. So he looked in the literature, he thought कि कोई प्लांट में इसी तरह का मुझे मॉलिक्यूल मिले जो कि मैं बहुत सिंपल दो तीन स्टेप्स करके इसको सिंथेसाइज करूं एंड ही वॉज सक्सेसफुल नेक्स्ट डायोसजेनेनिन नेक्स्ट डायोसजेनेनिन इज दिस स्ट्रक्चर एंड इट वॉज फाउंड इन अबंडेंस इन वन प्लांट एंड दैट प्लांट वॉज अवेलेबल इन मेक्सिको तो ये स्ट्रक्चर है अब नेक्स्ट करिएगा ये प्रोजेस्टोन नहीं नहीं प्लीज बैक ये प्रोजेस्टोन किस लुक एट फर्स्ट वन मिनट लुक एट द स्टीरियोकेमिस्ट्री डबल बॉन्ड ओ है वहीं पे OH आना है आपको पता है कि आराम से आ सकता है डबल बॉन्ड शिफ्ट करना है बाकी एंगुलर मिथाइल ग्रुप्स हैं स्टीरियोकेमिस्ट्री ABCD रिंग पूरी इंटैक्ट है थोड़ा सा पोर्शन उधर लगा है by doing simple reactions, he could convert it into four or five steps. Next, मैं पहले दिखाता हूँ आपको. देखिए, एसिटिक एनहाइड्राइड आप भी यूज करते हैं, क्रोमियम ट्राइऑक्साइड एसिटिक एसिड, कोई फैंसी रिएजेंट नहीं है, सोडियम हाइड्रोक्साइड इन एल्कोहल, कोई फैंसी रिएजेंट नहीं है, हाइड्रोजन प्लेडियम कोई बहुत इजीली कर सकते रिडक्शन, ब्रोमीन क्रोमियम ट्राइऑक्साइड जिंक सोडियम एसिटेट एसिटिक एसिड. सो दीज आर द वेरी सिंपल रिएजेंट ही यूज एंड ही हैज कन्वर्टेड डायोसिजनेनिन इनटू प्रोजेस्टेरोन. सो ही रोट दिस. सो देन ही स्टोरी इज वेरी लॉन्ग, आई विल कट शॉर्ट. He tried to convince Pond's laboratory people कि चलिए ये बनाते हैं, मैं बनाता हूँ, we will earn lot of money. They said no no no, we don't want to deal with Mexico. At that time it was considered to be very notorious drugs works का mafia और वो चलते थे. तभी वो जो border में wall erect करी थी उन्होंने, तभी उन्हीं दिनों में करी थी. Next, तो नहीं वापस चल जाइए, वापस चल जाइए. So he left the job, he went to Mexico. वहां से उसने not left, he took the permission, he went to Mexico. वहां से जाके roots, leaves, cabeza जो नाम है plant का, वहां समगल करके वो लेके आया और अपनी laboratory में आके 3 kg उसने progesterone बनाया successfully. And at that time $2,40,000 he earned from that. So he thought ki puri industry badi khush ho jayegi. But Americans are American. They said we don't care about this. We don't want to deal with Mexican people. They are very notorious. So he left the job. He went to Mexico. Wahan baat kari jo already choti industry thi, chemical industry, pharmaceutical industry. They started preparing this molecule. पूरी इंडस्ट्री चेंज, पूरा रेवोल्यूशन हो गया. इट इज नॉट ओनली द प्रोजेस्टेरोन, जो कॉन्ट्रासेप्टिव पिल्स कॉन्सेप्ट आया है, इट इज फ्रॉम दिस. प्रोजेस्टेरोन को थोड़ा चेंज किया, इफ यू सी द स्ट्रक्चर, ऑल द कॉन्ट्रास, पूरी स्टीरॉइड केमिस्ट्री चेंज हो गई, पूरा इंडस्ट्री चेंज हो गई. सो ही बिकेम इंडस्ट्रियलिस्ट, वेरी रिच पर्सन. और मैक्सिकन आर मैक्सिकन नोटोरियस पीपल. वन फाइन मॉर्निंग जब इस्टेब्लिश हो गया, अर्न कर लिया, they said okay bye, you go back to USA, ab aap se kuch nahi chahiye hame. So he picked up his bag, he went to another industry, dusre shehar mein, Mexico mein, pehle se baat kari hui thi. So he said ki main ye kiya hai main. He, by that time he was very renowned person, very rich person. So they said ki hum karenge to sahi aapke sath kaam, lekin wo to already aapka ek company aap establish kar rahe ho. So they are the competitor, they are doing so well. So don't worry, they will not able to make it. Jo last ke step hai, wo mere ko hi pata hai. Wo nahi maine unko disclose ki. He was so clever. So then he established his own company there. So and he changed the steroid chemistry in world. Next. So this was... But there is a dark side of the chemistry also. अच्छा काम करना, बुरा नहीं करना है. एक छोटी सी example लेके मैं बंद करूंगा. Next, ये this gentleman, you must be knowing this, Fritz Haber. नाम सुना बच्चों? Haber कहाँ से नाम सुना आपने? Haber process synthesis of ammonia. अमोनिया किस लिए इंपॉर्टेंट थी? अरे फर्टिलाइजर के लिए, अमोनियम क्लोराइड, अमोनियम जो भी सॉल्ट, अमोनियम के सल्फेट, नाइट्रेट सारे. सो ये कहा जाता है द मैन हु हैज फीडेड बिलियंस, हु फीड्स बिलियंस, पूरा रेवोल्यूशन, ग्रीन रेवोल्यूशन. फर्टिलाइजर यूज किया, इतनी क्रॉप्स आई, इतना यील्ड आई, पॉपुलेशन बढ़ रही थी, उसको कोप करने के लिए बहुत जरूरी था. बट ही गॉट द नोबेल प्राइज फॉर दिस वर्क 1918 में. बट अब ये कंप्लीट नहीं है, आप पूरा कंप्लीट करिए. हु फीड्स बिलियन एंड किल्ड मिलियंस. नेक्स्ट, इसका नेगेटिव आस्पेक्ट मैं बताऊं इनका. सो ये तो फर्टिलाइजर है. नेक्स्ट नेक्स्ट बॉश, ये बहुत सिंपल. हाइड्रोजन कहां से लिया? वाटर से. एयर लिया, और हाइड्रोजन नाइट्रोजन को मिक्स किया अमोनिया, आप मिक्स कर दिए रिएक्शन नहीं होती, यू नीड ए कैटलिस्ट एट हाई टेम्परेचर हाई प्रेशर, सिंपल कैटलिस्ट आयरन दे हैव टेकन एंड दे प्रिपेयर्ड दिस अमोनिया, ठीक है, ये यू नो ऑल दिस, आई वॉन्ट गो इन टू डिटेल नेक्स्ट, बट यू कैन सी दिस कार्टून पिक्चर, सो इट वॉज नॉट दैट पॉपुलर, उसको बहुत गंदी निगाह से देखते हैं जर्मन में अभी भी, ही वॉज एक्सपेल्ड फ्रॉम जर्मनी, क्यों, क्योंकि नाजीज के साथ वर्ल्ड वॉर वन में जो केमिकल वॉर, ही इज द फादर ऑफ केमिकल वॉरफेयर, ही ज्वाइन वर्ल्ड वॉर वन में ही ज्वाइन द आर्मी, नेक्स्ट, द फादर ऑफ केमिकल वॉरफेयर, नेक्स्ट, सो वॉरफेयर में केमिकल जो सबसे पहले यूज हुए थे अब तो बहुत बड़े बड़े हो गए, क्लोरीन, सिंपल क्लोरीन, सो वॉट ही डिड, ही सेड कि सिलेंडर ले आओ क्लोरीन के और खोल दो उसको, जहां पे सोल्जर ट्रेंचेस में केब्स में बना के जो कहते हैं ना नीचे बना के बैठे हैं, क्लोरीन इज हैवियर देन एयर, सो इट वेंट इनसाइड द टनल्स एंड जो सोए हुए थे सोल्जर दे ऑल वर किल्ड, इतने सोल्जर को, और दैट डेथ वॉज सो पेनफुल, क्योंकि वेन दे इनहेल्ड क्लोरीन इट केम इन कॉन्टेक्ट विद वॉटर, हाइड्रोक्लोरिक एसिड, यू नो हाउ डेंजरस इट इज, बना वो जो लाइनिंग आपकी गैस्ट्रिक लाइनिंग है, सो इट वॉज अ वेरी लाइक मस्टर्ड गैस, आपको पता है ब्लिस्टर्स हो जाते हैं, तो इट वॉज वेरी पेनफुल डेथ, नेक्स्ट, सो क्लोरीन गैस दे ओपनड इट लाइक दिस, इट्स द एक्चुअल पिक्चर आई हैव टेकन, नेक्स्ट, सो दे ऑल वर डेड in caves or the next, so his wife when she came to know ki my husband had joined, acha bahut secret hota tha, family member ko bhi nahi pata hota tha ki mera husband kya kar raha hai world war mein nazis mein, so when she came to know, very beautiful young lady, she committed suicide once she came to know ki mera husband chemical warfare mein involved hai, next, so between genius and back so this was between genius and genocide, so there were lot of movies, then they expelled this Fritz this. Okay, I will stop here and only two things I would like to mention more, main CV ki baat kar raha tha, bahut important hai bachcho aapke liye, main briefly aapko bataun ki aap jab bhi CV dein kisi bhi company mein, आपको बहुत सिंपल लेस इज मोर, एक वर्ड मेरा याद रखना, जितना एक होता ना कि मैं मैक्सिमम लिखूं सीवी के लिए, जो फर्स्ट सीवी होता है आपका, आप उल्टा याद करिए इसको, लेस इज मोर, इतना किसी के पास टाइम नहीं होता कि वो सारी चीज पढ़े, दे सिंपली स्कैन इट, आप सीपीसी में अप्लाई करते हैं ना, ऑनलाइन अप्लाई करते हो, जाते हो सीपीसी में, सेंट्रल प्लेसमेंट सेल, वहां कंपनीज आती हैं, आपका भी प्लेसमेंट सेल होगा वहां भी है, तो आप अप्लाई करिए विद वन कलर फोटोग्राफ, ठीक है, सबसे ऊपर कॉन्टेक्ट नंबर, कि उन्होंने सबसे पहले आपको फोन पे कॉन्टेक्ट एंड ईमेल से कॉन्टेक्ट करना है, ये सबसे पहले नाम हो गया कॉन्टेक्ट नंबर, उसके बाद जो आपकी क्वालिफिकेशन है, सिर्फ ग्रेजुएट है ना, क्रोनोलॉजिकल ऑर्डर में आप लिख दीजिएगा, और कोई इंटर्नशिप करी हो वो, कोई इंस्ट्रूमेंट टेक्निक आपने सीखी हो या किसी के साथ फैकल्टी के साथ आपने मिलकर सीख लीजिए, इनके पास इंस्ट्रूमेंट है वो बहुत काम आएगा, कंप्यूटर हर कोई लिखता है, 10th क्लास का बच्चा भी लिखना शुरू हो जाता है, वो तो आपको आना ही चाहिए, बट इंस्ट्रूमेंट जरूर लिख लीजिएगा, और दैट्स इट, वन पेज, डोंट गिव टू पेजेस, नो हॉबी, नथिंग, हॉबी सबकी बराबर है ना, तो ये एक पेज में आप लिखना है, और जब फोटो जो आपने देनी है, कोशिश करिएगा बाल ना, एक क्लियर पिक्चर होनी चाहिए, मैं बहुत सारी आपको फोटो दिखा सकता हूं सीवी की, मैंने एक्चुअल में ली है, साइड में फेस किया हुआ है, टी शर्ट पहनी हुई है, सो एक प्रॉपर ड्रेस लेके, एक बस वहीं से इंपैक्ट, अच्छा कई सीवी देते बिना फोटो के, अरे मेरे को 10 दीजिए, मैं आई वॉन्ट रिमेंबर एनीथिंग, फोटो होगी वो फोटो मेरे दिमाग में रहेगी, ठीक है, तो सीवी आप दीजिए, देन ग्रुप डिस्कशन में है, आप सुनिए उसको ठीक तरह से, उसको दीजिए, पढ़ के जाइए, हर कंपनी के लिए अपना अलग सीवी होना चाहिए, उस कंपनी के लिए थोड़ा सा जरूर पढ़ के जाइए, अदरवाइज देयर इज नो पॉइंट इन अपीयरिंग फॉर इंटरव्यू. जब आप इंटरव्यू में जाते हैं एक ठीक तरह से ड्रेस होके जाइए ना. जो विमेन है वो अपना सूट और इवन पैंट भी पहनी है, शर्ट पहनी है, एक प्रॉपर वे में होना चाहिए. ये हर चीज हम नोट करते हैं. अब बीइंग ए चेयरमैन, अब लेक्चरर की इंटरव्यू होती है, बिलीव मी यहाँ बैठे होते हैं, वहां से कैंडिडेट आता है, आधी इंटरव्यू वहीं खत्म हो जाती है जब वो आके बैठता है. बिलीव मी, एक लाइन बोलता है या दो लाइन बोलता है, हम कहते हैं एज ए चेयरमैन मैं बोलता हूँ, चाहे पॉलिटिकल साइंस की हो, इंट्रोड्यूस योर सेल्फ. आप हाउ कॉन्फिडेंटली यू आर इंट्रोड्यूसिंग योर सेल्फ, खत्म हो जाता है इंटरव्यू, वहीं पे हो जाता है. भाई आपने तो पढ़ के पढ़ाना है, बहुत लोग पढ़ा भी रहे हैं वो इंट्रोड्यूस ही नहीं करवा पा रहे हैं. सो फिर मैं कहता हूं कि ओके, जो आप पढ़ के आए हो आज इंटरव्यू के लिए, आप गो टू बोर्ड एंड पढ़ाइए हमें एक मिनट, यू जस्ट वॉन्ट टू सी योर टीचिंग स्किल, पढ़ के पढ़ाना, सारी बुक्स हैं. अगर आपको बुक्स के नाम ही याद नहीं है तो क्या पढ़ाओगे आप बुक्स? आधे लोगों को बुक्स के नाम ही नहीं पता होते. यही नहीं पता होता दिल्ली यूनिवर्सिटी का सिलेबस क्या है, यही नहीं पता होता क्रेडिट कितने हैं, कौन सा हम फॉर्मेट यूज कर रहे हैं फर्स्ट सेमेस्टर में. जी अब नॉमेनक्लेचर चेंज हो गया है, आप भी जब भी आप कभी इंटरव्यू दीजिए ये चीजें भूलनी नहीं है, कितने क्रेडिट करके आए हो, कौन कौन से पेपर पढ़ के आए हो, ये नाम रखिएगा. सो विद ऑल दिस वर्ड्स, बहुत लंबा है लेक्चर, तो आई कैन कीप ऑन मूविंग, बट थैंक यू सो मच फॉर लिसनिंग मी एंड थैंक्स, थैंक यू सो मच अगेन डॉक्टर साहब लेट आए हैं फॉर गिविंग मी दिस अपॉर्चुनिटी टू इंटरेक्ट विद यू. थैंक यू सो मच.
Thank you, sir. It was an enriching talk. If someone wants to ask a question, they can ask. Since no one has questions, moving forward, I request. Okay.
और खालसा कॉलेज में इनिशिएटिव कोई कोर्स वोर्स शुरू किया था प्रोफेसर सोनी, फॉरेंसिक साइंस हमारे एज सच नहीं है इसमें, लेकिन फॉरेन में बहुत सारी यूनिवर्सिटीज में है, सिंगापुर यूनिवर्सिटी में, नान्यांग यूनिवर्सिटी में, बहुत अच्छा है. एंड पता नहीं आपका कॉलेज थोड़ा दूर है, ही केम एंड ही सेड कि आई वांटेड टू डिलीवर लेक्चर ऑन फॉरेंसिक साइंस, सो आई टुक हिम टू खालसा कॉलेज. आप बाकी फॉरेन की यूनिवर्सिटीज में, इंडिया में बहुत ज्यादा फॉरेंसिक साइंस पे काम नहीं हुआ, अगर आप भी करना चाहें रिसर्च में तो कर सकते हैं. यूनिवर्सिटी में आप सर्च करेंगे और भी यूनिवर्सिटीज है एंथ्रोपोलॉजी से रिलेटेड, और केमिस्ट्री में हमारे कुछ पीएचडी स्टूडेंट हमने लिए थे जिन्होंने फॉरेंसिक साइंस में एमएससी पास. नैनयांग यूनिवर्सिटी, नैनयांग सिंगापुर. मैं मुझे उसका लेक्चर का एक बहुत ब्यूटीफुल उसका याद है, उसने बड़े सारे इंसिडेंट लिए, मर्डर वाले, ये वाले, प्लांट बेस्ड, ड्रग बेस्ड, वो वाला. तो ही सेड कि एक्सेस ऑफ एवरीथिंग इज बैड, कि वन कैन डाई बाय टेकिंग सिंपल वाटर, एक्सेस ऑफ एवरीथिंग इज बैड. तो दैट वाज इट वाज ब्यूटीफुल. अगर वो कभी आते हैं तो ऑल द बेस्ट.
जैसे हमने इंटरेक्ट वहां बैठे मेटल के साथ इंटरेक्ट किया लाइगन के बहुत सारे फंक्शनल ग्रुप है हमें नहीं पता किसके साथ कर रहा है जब तो उसका हम एक्सरे करते हैं फिर हम डीएफटी कैलकुलेशन करते हैं बहुत लोग करते हैं प्रैक्टिकल तो उससे कंफर्म करते हैं कि हाँ इसी के साथ बाइंडिंग हो रही है अब हम उसके ब्रॉड प्लॉट करते हैं स्कर्ट वॉल पर और बहुत सारे उसमें हम ए एसोसिएशन देखते हैं कि बहुत स्ट्रॉन्ग होती है एसोसिएशन इस टेम्परेचर के टेम्परेचर इफेक्ट वो सारी स्टडीज करते हैं वो मैंने दिखाया है फुल पेपर होता है अगर तो बहुत स्ट्रॉन्ग उसके साथ है मेटल के साथ तो वो अच्छा कैलोसेंसर नहीं है ठीक है फिर उसके बाद हम ईडीटीए डाला ईडीटीए ने रिप्लेस कर दिया मेटल को तो ये सारी चीजें हम देखते हैं अगर Not only metal, अगर amino acid या किसी molecule, biomolecule को हमने insect के body में करना है, carrier है, carrier भी लेके जाना है, drug carrier, तो वो drug जो carrier होते हैं, वो binding उतनी होनी चाहिए, ADME study करवाते हैं, फिर वो release भी करें, ये mechanism दोनों, ये chain को release कर दिया, दूसरा आ गया ligand तो तब release कर दिया, और strong binding भी नहीं है
ये करेक्ट नहीं है अभी जैसे कोरोना काल में वैक्सीन आया हर एक कंट्री जो यूएसए पहले निकाला फाइजर निकाला सबको नहीं दिया जब अपना कंट्री में ये कर दिया उसके बाद दिया या हमने इंडिया में भी पहले अपने नॉन सिटीजन को दिया फिर ये किया तो कैसे ये स्टेटमेंट कंट्राडिक्ट करता साइंटिस्टों
ये साइंटिस्ट ब्रॉट टू हिज कंट्री इन टाइम्स ऑफ वॉर And all men
Americans with a recent discovery करता किसी को देता नहीं
नहीं ये उसने ये statement दी थी कि I'm a scientist मैंने chemistry के लिए कुछ किया फिर later on पता नहीं क्या दिमाग change होता है इस तरह की देखिए पहले मेरा mission मैं अपने nation आज today the need is कि उनको लड़ाई जितवा दूँ मैं किसी भी एक्सटेंट में जा सकता हूँ अभी मेरे फोटो ने दिखाई गा ये फोटो है इस इन दैट ड्रेस पूरा आर्मी वाली पर रहा इस सर की वो साइंटिस्ट आ हमने कर लिया और भी इसकी बहुत सारी है बट मैं मेरा नेशन आज स्ट्रेस में है उसमें लड़ाई गई है मैं हेल्प करूंगा उसकी
सर ये हम सब कहते हैं हमारा नेशन पास ऐसा नहीं है कि मुझे नहीं लगता कि उसके स्टेटमेंट में कोई रॉन्ग है या अनएथिकल है
उसके लिए तो ठीक है वो ठीक है बिल्कुल ठीक है उसके वैक्सीन वाला भी यही है कि हर कंट्री अपने आप को पहले प्रोटेक्ट करता है बट इवन वी आर प्राउड ऑफ आवर गवर्नमेंट मोदी जी कि उन्होंने आप हमें तो पता नहीं इतनी वैक्सीन बाहर भेजी है बहुत बहुत ज्यादा
मेरा पॉइंट है सर पहले अपने कंट्री में लिया ना फिर
बिल्कुल जो हम केमिस्ट्री है वो अपने बेनिफिट के लिए यूज करें वो बेटर उसको नेगेटिव
सर जो पेटेंट हम लगाते हैं जो डेवलप्ड कंट्री है पेटेंट लगा के ड्रग्स रिसेंट ड्रग्स आया कार डेवलपिंग कंट्री को ये देता है कि मैं तुम यूज करो
टेक्निक इट्स ए बिग अगर हम डिस्कशन शुरू करें तो बहुत लंबी डिस्कशन है इसमें बहुत नेगेटिव एस्पेक्ट है बहुत पॉजिटिव है मैंने पीएचडी के बाद रेनवैक्सी ज्वाइन करी
और फर्स्ट प्रोजेक्ट जो मेरे को दिया था रेनेटी दी मैं मेरे को वो ज्वाइन किया तो उन्होंने कहा कि पराशर जी आप रेनेटी टीम की सिंथेसिस करनी है यू आर गुड इन ऑर्गेनिक सिंथेसिस आप रहिए लाइब्रेरी में लिखे लाइए जितने कम से कम स्टेप में हो सके आई वाज वेरी हैप्पी यूनिवर्सिटी जाता था अपनी लैब में जाता था लाइब्रेरी में बैठता था दो घंटे लिख के ले आता था मैं एक महीने के बाद गया वापिस आई शोड इट टू खन्ना ऑफिस एक वाइस प्रेसिडेंट था तो ही कॉल्ड द मीटिंग 10 12 लोग बैठे थे 12 तक आई रिटर्न दिस सिंथेसिस दैट इज लिखी रहे तो दे स्टार्टेड लाफिंग मैंने सोचा रहे कोई गलती होगी तो दे सेड कि अरे भाई ये तो हम सिंथेसाइज कर रहे हैं आपको तो इसी मेथड से कर रहे हैं आपको तो कोई और मेथड ढूंढने के लिए कहा गया कि बस लाफिंग इन गुड सेंस कि उनको ये लगा कि एटलीस्ट बच्चे ने लिखा है वही कर मींस कि वो पेटेंट किसी ने करवाया हुआ है एंड फ्लेक्सिबल पेइंग क्योंकि वो मेथड से यूज करते हैं अगर हम या तो प्रोडक्ट करें या मेथड करें तो वी नीड टू पे फॉर तो दे वांटेड टू डेवलप अनदर मेथड और अदर अब मैं बात नहीं करना चाह रहा कि अब तो खैर कितने साल हो गए हैं तो फिर हमने लिखी यूएसए से किसी और को भी हायर किया था तो टीडीएस लिख के दी पेटेंट करवाया बनाते उसी से जो पहले वाला था who is coming going to come and see कि किसने बनाया एक दो इंटरमीडिएट बना लिए दिखाने के लिए कि ये है वो कंपनी है मैं let me be very honest इतनी आपकी ड्रग एंटी कैंसर वाली है सर्वाइवल रेट इज वेरी लेस 100 में से एक 5-10 उससे ज्यादा वो कहते हैं इंडस्ट्री की हमने एक ड्रग में आने में 20 साल की रिसर्च लगाई और बिलियंस ऑफ रुपीस दे हैव स्पेंट वो जब तक कवर नहीं हो जाएगा हम दूसरी ड्रग आ रहे हैं इसलिए नहीं अभी मेरे को एंटी कैंसर बहुत सारी और भी आपकी आ सकती है इसलिए नहीं Dark side of chemistry, dark side of this molecule.
Moving forward. I request Professor, Ma'am, Namita Gandhi to please introduce our guest of honor, Professor Sir Anil Kumar, Head of Department of Applied Chemistry, Delhi Technological University. Students, please sit. We are going forward with the program. Please sit down. Students sitting in the back, please settle down. Moving forward, good noon to all. It is my privilege to introduce our guest of honor, Dr. Anil Kumar, who is at present Professor and Head, Department of Applied Chemistry, Delhi Technological University. After doing MSc from IIT Roorkee, he completed his PhD from IIT Kanpur in 2006. He did his postdoctoral fellowship from Institute of Chemistry, Academia Sincia, Taipei, Taiwan, and Faculty of Chemistry from Technion, Israel, University of Technology, Israel. Later, he joined DTU as Assistant Professor in 2018. He has received several commendable research excellence awards from year 2018 to 2023. He has been visiting Associate Professor, Faculty of Chemistry, Technion, IIT Israel from January 2020 to 21. He has 48 publications in journals of repute to his credit and 5 book chapters. He has delivered invited lectures in number of national and international conferences, seminars, and symposia. Under his supervision, 9 PhDs have already been awarded and 3 are at present ongoing. I welcome you, sir, and invite you for your talk.
Namaskar.
पॉइंटर है।
नेक्स्ट नेक्स्ट पहला ये
First of all, thank you, Professor Gandhi, for nice and kind introduction. And respected Professor R.K. Pandeji, principal in absentia, and faculty colleagues, and dear students, a very good morning to all of you. Today, actually, Professor Prasar explained about the what basically the chemistry people can do, where they can get a job, and what is the career after doing BSc and MSc. So, my talk basically generally will focus more on the what exactly that people are doing in porphyrin chemistry. And I think the people from the BSc third year, they must know that porphyrin basically is the one of the important a molecule in the all kind of hemoglobin enzymes in the body, which they carry out several functions like cytochromes and hemoglobins. And in the nature also, you can see that all the tree, but the green color is because of this chlorophyll that also contains this kind of the moiety, that macrocyclic moiety. So I think the students, maybe from the 30th, have you read this something like hemoglobin and other things? How many students are from third year here? Third year chemistry honors, sir, but okay. Oh, whatever, but I think chemistry people know that what exactly in the in the blood, which is the active basically molecule, and in the chlorophyll, one of the most important molecule in the plants, which has the green color due to the this chlorophyll only. So the first, I'll start with my department. I think this is the first time I am visiting to this college. And earlier I came here for the admission in 1993, I did my BSc from only the Delhi University, from Jackson College. So our department basically applied chemistry, and applied chemistry department, we have the vision to be leading center of excellence for education, research and innovation in the field of chemistry, chemical engineering and polymer technology to produce socially responsible, environmentally sensitive technology. This is the vision of our department, and this is in the line of our university, that we want to have the world-class technical university. And we have the few missions of our department. We want to establish a department, a thriving center of excellence in technical education and research, to create an environment of active collaboration and innovation for sustainable and technology development, to channelize human potential to the fullest for addressing the problem of social importance, and to facilitate the transformation of students from education seeker to entrepreneur. The last is the from education to seeker entrepreneur. And this is the one of the most important mission of the any technical research department, because the everybody want to have job, but we should have the job giver, because the government also want that one subject should create the jobs, not to capture the job. That is more important mission of the every department in our university, that we want to create the entrepreneurs from the specialized courses. Our department basically running the BTech in chemical engineering, that is the intake of 75. This intake is from the JE main exam, and it's 4 years, that all of you know that. And then MSc chemistry, and this is the second batch of MSc chemistry will pass out this year, and the intake is 760, and that is through the JEM. At PhD, we have the in chemistry and chemical engineering separately. That all depends on the intake is depend on the requirement of the faculty member, that who they want to have. And our university was basically established in 1941 as a Delhi Polytechnic. Later, it was converted to Delhi College of Engineering. And recently, in 1999, it was fully converted to the autonomous Delhi Technological University by Delhi government. Now we have almost 15 BTech engineering courses and 4 MSc program, MSc in biotechnology, MSc in physics, MSc in mathematics, and MSc in chemistry. All the 4 courses started very recently. Only the second or third batch are going to complete this year. Please, next slide, please. Next. So my talk, basically the contents should cover the coral chemistry, manganese, phosphorus, cobalt, and these are all the porphyrin molecules that I already told that the molecules, which is basically the basic entity of our the blood, that is hemoglobin, which contains the porphyrin. But it's not exactly the same entity, but it's a related to the close related to the that molecule. So if you want to know about the porphyrin, that is the is a pigments of life. Why pigment of life? Because the hemoglobin vesicle are tetrapyrolic moiety. It is basically this can be synthesized by using the pyrrole and India. This contains four pyrrole moiety connected through the carbon. These are very stable, dynamic, and aromatic. It's highly aromatic in nature. You can see from the how do you basically analyze the aromaticity in the molecule, organic molecule. Can you tell me any chemistry student? How do you know the molecules are aromatic in nature? Yes. Okay, okay. Maybe the first test. Yeah. Okay. Then chemistry of porphyrin derivative have attracted significant attention because its potential application like molecular devices, dye sensorizing solar cell, photodynamic therapy, and the molecular devices, dye sensorizing solar cell, and for the dye sensors are also being used. That you know that so nowadays the government is also creating attention toward the hybrid energy because they are moving toward petrol to the battery system. So we need the solar cell system. So the molecules, these kind of molecule can be used in the solar cell also. Photodynamic therapy, that all you know that in cancer therapy that people are curing for the photodynamic therapy, and because the photodynamic therapy, that they absorb the light and emit the light. Porphyrins are important because of their multiple biological functions and their ability to bind with a number of transcriptions. They are very, very basically, they can act as a basically good ligands which can bind with the different kind of metals, dimetal ion, and can create so many applications in that area. These may be altered in a wide number of ways, which allows them to give birth to many other important molecules. This is a simple molecule, but it can be modified according to our use. Please, next slide. You can see that this is the simple porphyrin molecule that these are called mesocarbons, these four mesocarbon here, and this is the, I told you that is tetrapyrolic moiety. They are tetrapyrolic moiety. So you can see that its synthesis is very easy. You can take the pyrrole and you can take LDH, which can condense together here, which can condense. And in my God, but these the sites where the modification can be done because these contains hydrogen here, and the beta hydrogen can easily be removable by using some other atom. And these are mesocarbon. And this is the core modified by replacing this. If you can replace the nitrogen here, because you are taking the pyrrole here, you can take the furans, thiophene also you can take here, and you can synthesize the heterocycline molecule here also. So this is a core modified by replacing the hydrogen atom N with hetero atom, and this is called contracted porphyrin. Contracted means that you are reducing the macrocyclic system to the lesser number. You can see here that this is the in porphyrin we have four mesocarbon. But here you have three. This is called contracted porphyrin, and this is called coral. This is porphyrin. This is called coral. The next slide. So, okay, and you can see that you can also modify by using this contrast coral. You can also expand. Expansion is more important because when you expand it, the color becomes very beautiful, and you are going toward the more visible side. Every compound should have the more visible region. Why the more visible region? Because if you want to use in the photodynamic therapy, you should have the higher visible, this higher wavelength, because higher wavelength will have the lesser tissue damage. The energy would be lesser because you know that higher the wavelength, the lesser will be the energy. Okay. Now come to the this inversion can be done. This sometimes while synthesizing, this get inverted and you get the inversion N-confused porphyrin. And this is the carboporphyrin. When the one of the this pyrrolic moiety is replaced by the this porphyrin, this basically the benzene type containing the two sp3 hybridized carbon here and one phenylalanine. That is called carboporphyrins here. Next slide, please. So these are the modifications that I already told you that these are the major basically modification where the modification can be done. Beta hydrogen and the core, basically inner core, we can also basically modify here, and we can have the number of the different kind of molecule which can be used for different kind of purposes. Next slide, please. So this is about the introduction of porphyrin. Where the porphyrins are basically found in the our biological system and also in the nature plants. So come to the corals that I told that in coral basically the we are the contracted porphyrin. It's one of the class of the this porphyrin molecule, and that is very important. The first time it was synthesized in 1960. This was synthesized serendipitically because the people want to synthesize the vitamin B12, but they end up with the this molecule that is called a choline type macrocycle, and later they analyze and determine the structure that is the one. This is the coral molecule, and this is also tetrapyrrolic derivative. It is constituted with 3 mesocarbons and 1 direct pyrrole-pyrrole linkage. Means the direct pyrrole-pyrrole linkage was there, and the coral macrocycle is a 19 atom carbon structure aromatic. The whole macrocyclic, the aromatic conjugation pathway is same in the porphyrin 18 pyrrole lectin, and also in coral also the 18 pyrrole lectin in the one cycle, conjugation cycle, aromaticity. Next, please. This is the corine that basically found in the our vitamin B12. You can see this is the also the beta linkage here, alpha linkage here. But and you can see also that coral is also have the linkage to the carbon-carbon linkage here. So this resembles the corine here. And in corine also we have the cobalt in the central atom. And the coral also, if you want to have the cobalt, you can also introduce cobalt here. And that is also you can say that with the coral has the similar structure, not exactly similar structure, because the corine is not completely aromatic in nature. It is basically the conjugation pathway is basically attenuated here, but the coral is completely aromatic in nature. And this is the porphyrin that we know that. Next slide, please. The central region of core molecule is NN core, that we have all 4 N core and surrounded by 4 pyrrolate atom as shown in figure. And these basically, this coral without metal is called free base coral, and this can be ABA, A2B, ABC, depending on this mesocarbon. If you have all the mesocarbon have the same substituent, this is called A3. For example, if you have the phenylene here, this is A3 coral. If you have the one here different, two same here, one different, that is called ABA or A2B. And if you have all 3 different meso substituent, then you can have the ABC coral. And these are very important. These meso basically positions, if you have the electron withdrawing, electron releasing group, if you attack, their property will be drastically changed here. Please, next slide. Okay, next, please. Okay. So these are some of the important that how to synthesize these different kind of corals here. If you want to synthesize A3 coral, I told that this is the tetrapyrrolic moiety. If you take the pyrrole, and this aldehyde you can take, and this condensation in the acid catalyzed condensation, very simple reaction. Even you can start in the BSc, we have in MSc first year program that you can synthesize coral or porphyrin here. You take the pyrrole, you take the aldehyde, and add into the TFA, and easily synthesize the coral. Very colorful molecule here. So all these kind of corals, different kind of coral, they have the different synthesis, like A3 coral, CCA2B. Cis means you have the both the A and B, cis A here, and this is a trans A to B, and ABC coral, we have the different kind of the disc moieties also. Please. Since the discovery of coral in 1960, the coral field was largely dominant, but in 1999, if you look into the next slide, please. Yeah. If you look into the literature survey, if you do that, up to 1999, you can find a lesser publication was there. The people have used this molecule. In literature, the synthesis was very less because the synthesis was very difficult, and also the yield was very less. You can see that whatever molecule you see people are using, those synthesis are very convenient and useful. They are basically largely used. But before 1999, this molecule was not being used in the research because the synthesis was very difficult, yield was very difficult. But in 1999, the Gross et al. From Israel Institute of Technology, he developed a very new protocol in 1999, a one-pore synthesis of this molecule by using the pyrrole, aldehyde, using TFA in dry condition, just by workup and column chromatography separation. He got the yield of 20% yield, and that basically go back to the cell, please. Yeah. And 1999, the simultaneously two research groups, the Gross from Israeli and Pellers from the Italy, they independently developed one this method to synthesize the coral from pyrrole and aromatic aldehyde. And this method revolutionized the coral chemistry in the late. Even though the illustration was low, but the preparation of these molecules just step was an important research. In any short time, the number of publications on this topic increased. You can see that from after 99, you can see the publication is very, very high. In the last year, you can see the 140 paper published related to coral, and till 2022, more than 200 paper published in this area. Next slide, please. This is the proposed research that synthetic method that you can see that is very simple. They have used the aldehyde, any aromatic aldehyde you can take, and you can take the pyrrole, TFA, triphosphate in DCM, just stir it, and for the oxidation you can use the DDQ. This is very strong, although it's very strong oxidizing, you can use the other oxidizing like paraquinol, but DDQ is a very good oxidant, and you can synthesize this macrocyclic in a very good yield. They have used different kind of the aromatic aldehyde here. They have pentafluoro, pentadifluoropent, and depending on the use and what kind of here you want to use that substituent you can take. But nowadays, almost all the aromatic aldehyde can be used for the synthesis of coral. Next, please. This is the another protocol, and in 1999, the Gross and Pellows developed this method in non-aqueous media, means they have used the basically the organic solvent. But in 2004, this basically another scientist, that is the Greco, D.T. Greco from Poland, he developed a method, very good simple method. You can see that they have used only the water in methanol mixture. This is the, you can see that this is the green chemistry, one of the important step green chemistry, that they have used the water and methanol mixture and added HCl. Simple, and stirring for 2 hours, they can basically collected this bilane. This is the bilane, means the without cyclized molecule, and they have separated out it and oxidized in a very simple they can use the paraquinoline in chloroform, and overnight stirring, you can get the this compound in a very good. So this in 1999 and after 2003, there are two different methods which basically revolutionized the coral chemistry after the good yield synthesis. Next slide, please. Now, looking apart from the this basically the synthetic part and how the this molecule was invented and how the publications and research revolutionized by using this developed method, the different they have the different kind of properties. Coral can stabilize high formal oxidation of metal ion manganese 3. You can stabilize because in porphyrin you can see that they have the dianion molecule, because the only the 2H can be replaced by the metal ion, but in coral you have the 3 NH proton here, H. So you can replace 3, which means you can stabilize the high valent metal. That is the more important for the all kind of the catalysis property. So, and one of the important coral that can stabilize chromium, the one single metal can be stabilized in different of like chromium 3, 4, 5 and 6. Even the manganese can be stabilized into the 3, 4, 5, iron 4, cobalt 4 and cobalt. So these are the one of different kind of metal atoms in different oxidation can be still by using this kind of molecule. And corals form very tight conjugate with protein. Nowadays, the corals are being used in the diabetes and osteoclerosis disease also, because if you use the coral, the poorly charged coral, because the most of the basically biological systems, people are working in the ecosystem only. So we need to have the molecule to be soluble in water. So there are two methods to solubilize. Either it should be cationic in nature, it means it should have the salt nature. Is cationic or anionic? So you can have the cationic here, so you can easily use water soluble, or you can have the even the anionic nature also by using the, how can you do the anionic nature? Just sulfonate this molecule, you have the sulfonation. By simple, take this molecule, add concentration spore, grind it, simple grinding, no need to take the molecule, take the H2O4, grind it, add acetone, and you will get the this anionic molecule, the sulfide. So these basically can easily tightly form conjugate with the protein, and you can use a number of different kind of biological systems here. So different in you can see that there are different kind of areas where the these corals can be used. In non-aeroptics we can use, solar cell, you can make the conjugate with the nanotubes also. You can use the catalysis like epoxidation catalysis, oxidation catalysis. Even nowadays, the reduction catalysis is more important. You can use the optical imaging, you can for the photon traffic, and you can use for the sensing molecule. Please, next. So, next. So, you can see here that nowadays, till now in 2024, you can see the where the these colors are there. All the metal atoms have been used to coordinate with the coral molecules, and they have the different uses in different. For example, if you take the gallium, gallium is being used the cell imaging, and phosphorus is also being cell imaging. Cobalt is used for the reduction electroreduction catalysis. Manganese for the oxygen catalysis. Even the iron is also used for the oxygen catalysis. There are some important feature of corals. Corals have high NH acidity because there are three NH proton here. Diverse catalytic property, and it can stabilize high valent and unique photophysical property. So you can use the catalysis, you can use atherosclerosis prevention and tumor elimination also, like photodynamic therapy. You can, the people are using here, the gallium corals are used because they are highly fluorescent molecule. Even gallium, aluminium and phosphorus are highly fluorescent molecules here. Next slide. Even the now people are using the nitrate reduction also. You can say they are using the nitrate to the for the evolution of the nitrogen here. The manganese 3 corals are being used, and this is the this paper was published with the Professor Abhishek Day from ISS Kolkata. There are four, so many reactive oxygen species and reactive nitrate species are being used the corals here. And corals are also using the sensor volume diverse detection mode, that optical detection, spectral modes, electronic, electrochemical modes, so different modes of detection, like the Professor Prasad told, the chemo sensor also. And naked eye detection also the people are using for the this coral molecules for the this kind of sensors. Next slide. So so now come to the actual chemistry. What basically the, how to characterize a molecule, because that is more important. If you synthesize the molecule, the characterization is more important. So how to characterize a molecule? Suppose you synthesize a molecule, first is the you will take the UV visual spectroscopy, that how the UV visual looks like it. If the compound is more conjugated, you will have the absorbance in the more visible region. And if it's aromatic in nature, the NMR will be very nice. So if you take the NMR of this molecule, you can see that there are three NH here, proton here. These three NH protons are in the ring current. They are the and highly aromatic nature. So they are more off-filled. Because they are NH, they are these inner NH are basically highly shielded. They will go to the more off-field, means they are towards the more negative region. They will, so you will see the these signals in the more negative region, and these are basically are the this 8 pyrrole proton. You will have the doublet of this one, because this will couple this one and this will couple with this one likewise. So each signal you will have a doublet. So it means you have the 4 doublet signal. Each proton has the 2. So you can see that doublet 4 doublet and 1 signal in the negative region, and this next slide. Also, these you can see that the doublet of this, you can see the 4 doublet would be there. These are coupled doublet because this was taken at 400 megahertz NMR. If you go with the higher frequency in the NMR, you'll have the separate one. So this is the way that how to the one of the most important spectral technique is the UV spectroscopy, because the how the molecule absorbs the UV visual radiation and transmit. If the more conjugation there, you'll have the more visible region. If now second is the for this kind of molecule, you have the NMR. How the NMR looks, whether the NMR looks like aromatic in nature, whether the NMR looks aliphatic in nature, and where the proton will come, how the protons are coupled with the sided protons. Next slide, please. Also, the mass, next technique is the mass spectroscopy, mass spectrometry, that how the compound mass, total mass, molecular weight. So you can find out by using the ESI. High resolution mass spectra people are using, that have the compounds ka jo hai kitna uska molecular weight hai. So you can easily find out by using the mass spectrometry. And if the mass NMR, how many protons are there, and UV spectroscopy match with this one, it means you can say that I have synthesized the molecule which looks like the porphyrin. Next one. And last is the basically would be the crystal, single crystal. If you are taking any bushing, the last technique is the single crystallography, that you have synthesized the molecule, you know that how it's behaving with the UV visible, how it absorbing light, second how the NMR looks like, and third is the mass looks the same what I synthesized. then you will go for the higher spectral technique that is called X-ray crystallography. X-ray will give you the three-dimensional structure of the molecule. That how the molecules looks like, where the protons are there, where the carbon, how they are basically attached to the each kind of the bulk atom. So this is the UV spectrum of different kind of, you can see that this basically, you can see the strong band that is called SORET band. SORET basically the name of scientists, where the 400 to 450 nanometer, if the, any molecule absorbs, that is called SORET band. So SORET band is the prominent feature of the, this kind of porphyrin molecule. And this is the if you are taking the molecule, you are coordinating with the manganese compound, it means the symmetry is totally changing. You know, the based on the symmetry, you'll have the symmetry element and you'll have the different kind of electronic spectra you can get. So if you take the free base, means without metal, coordinating with the metal with the ligand, and you'll have the different. So you can say that my compound has been ligated to the metal center, and my now it is coordination complex, manganese 3 complex. If this compound is manganese 3, I told you that the corals basically are known to stabilize the high valent basically metal ions in the. So if you take the manganese 3 and you just oxidize the manganese 3, if you take the MCPBA, metachlorpyrimethic acid, you can take the easily the metal can be easily oxidized. But if you are, we are taking here the ozone. Ozone is a very clean oxidant. Why it is clean oxidant? Why the ozone is very clean oxidant? Because if you are taking the organic oxidant like metachlorpyrimethic acid, any oxidant, they will leave the side product, and it's very difficult to analyze. They will create the interference while analyzing the NMR. But if you are taking the ozone, you take the ozone, manganese 3 complex, pass the ozone, this will oxidize the manganese 3 to the manganese 5. Immediately the color will change from green to red color. That is the way that my compound is now manganese 5, and you have the split SORET band. The red color compound is manganese 5. This manganese 5 compound is very important because manganese 5 is not so stable. Manganese 5, that is good for the catalysis, because you should not have the stable compound. You need to transfer the oxygen from the metal to the substrate. So if you take the manganese 3, pass the ozone, it will turn into the manganese 5. Become the highly unstable oxidant, add substrate, it will transfer the oxygen to the substrate and will oxidize the substrate. This is very simple catalysis they have done. Next slide, please. So this is the molecule that I told you that this is the manganese 5, and it is how the confirm that this is manganese 5. Manganese 5 is usually basically D2. Manganese 5 kitna hoga? D2 hoga na? Because D5-4S2. But it should be paramagnetic nature. According to the theory, it should be paramagnetic. But if you take the NMR of this compound, it is diamagnetic. You can see from the NMR, it is perfectly diamagnetic in nature, because the paramagnetic NMR will have the broad peak in the NMR signal. Sometimes it's very difficult to take the NMR of the paramagnetic compound, but you see the this NMR looks like very clean NMR, and this manganese is oxidized and is formed the triple bond with the oxygen. And that was the basically the recent. Now the people have also stabilized the structure. They have also determined the crystal structure of manganese 3-5, and how this is basically paramagnetic. You can see that they are the nor pi bonding electron in dxy, in nor pi bonding electron in dxy orbital, the electrons get pair. That is the basically the one of the important parameter that manganese 5 is the diamagnetic nature, and it is completely stable, not that much stable compound, and it can easily oxidize the. So but if it is not stable, how the people can take the NMR? This one, it means the stable at, it is not stable at room temperature, but it's stable at very low temperature. It means if you minus 20 degree temperature, if you take the liquid solid carbon dioxide, you take the compound in solution state and keep it there, it is stable for a longer time. So now this is about the basically the, I told you about the manganese coral and the how the basic coral chemistry. Now come to the phosphorus coral. Phosphorus is also very important. Phosphorus basically is highly fluorescent molecule. If the phosphorus coral is highly fluorescent, and this can be easily synthesized by using different methods. And these are the basically how to characterize. I told you that first step to characterize any this kind of porphyrin molecule is the basically the UV spectroscopy. And if you take record the UV spectroscopy, you can see the very sharp band in the region of 400 to 450. Very sharp band. And these are the Q bands are called. If you do that 427 to 452, these all depend on the substituent attached on the basically the mesocarbons and the beta hydrogen H. They are the, because the electronic basically the UV spectroscopy all depend on the electronic state. The electronic states depend on the how the substituent are attached on that molecule. Electron withdrawing or electron releasing. Electron withdrawing push the electron density toward their side, so the energy will suffer and you will have the lower side or higher side the UV spectroscope. Please. Next. So these are the, when we synthesize this phosphorus compound, this is the, you can see that one of the important important parameter while going for the basically research, or if you are doing any kind of project in BSc or MSc, the most important property is the observation. You have to observe that it doesn't mean that whatever compound you have taken, that is the, that only the form. Maybe the some is important information you can get it from here. For example, if you take this compound, my students inside this compound with the phosphorus, and you have the two hydroxyl group here. When he record the NMR, he has seen that you can see that there are some small peaks here nearby. You can see. Please, next slide. I haven't taken the last section of this one. So you can see that this phosphorus is then hexacoordinate state. But if you see the NMR, you should see the NMR only four doublet here because of this four doublet only. And it's hydroxyl is because symmetrical molecule, so you'll have the one hydroxyl for the one peak only. But when she recorded NMR from, she found that there are some small peaks in the same doublet here. It means there is something basically equilibrium state is there. It means this phosphorus hexacoordinator, this is a hexacoordinator, it is in equilibrium with the pentacoordinator in the solution state. It means it is in the pentacoordinator, it is in the hexacoordinator. Because when he recorded the phosphorus NMR, then what she did, she recorded the phosphorus NMR. Because phosphorus pentacoordinator NMR would be different and hexacoordinator NMR would be different. So she observed two peaks here at minus 100 and minus 190. So this corresponds to the pentas and this corresponds to the hexa. It means these compounds exist in the equilibrium state in the penta and the hexa. In the solution state, if you are having the only the OH group here. But if you want to have the completely six coordinate state, you have to synthesize the, you have to replace this OH with the bulkier group like methanol. You can take methanol, you can take the siloxyl, with siloxyl you can take. So they can stabilize this hexa coordination phosphorus compound. And if you record those NMR of those compound, you will see only one single peak and four doublets, very sharp doublet. So this this was the nice observation she did, that this phosphorus compound can be within the, so this is the important property for all the students who are want to have the MSc dissertation and the research point of view, that you have to observe, you have to nicely find out what you are doing, whether not go for that whatever the sir told that this is the, I got it. No, you have to go into detail that whether the observation are right or whether something is new coming out from that one. Next, please. So the photophysical studies, because the phosphorus are very, very prominent fluorescent in nature. So they have a strong fluorescence band around 615 nanometer, and which are slightly red shifted compared to what I reported. So this is the all depend on the quantum yields 0.33 to 0.49. This is the promising quantum yield, and this is more than the porphyrin molecule. Next, please. Okay, so we also did the photophysical study. That photophysical means the fluorescence spectra. What we do exactly, we take the compound and excite at the particular wavelength by using the laser. For example, this compound we excited at 500 nanometer, for example. So after absorbing the light, it emits the light, and we observe this is the emission light that we are getting, the emission spectra. It means when, for example, this compound, how the people are using for the photo, for example, this compound, they will take this compound and will inject in the, basically if they want to the in vitro study in the cell, and they will inject this compound in the some kind of animal, and this compound will accumulate in the tumors where the tumor is there. Now whatever they will light this tumor in the visible region, because visible region is more important, because you have to use only visible region. You cannot use the UV region, because the UV is basically dangerous to the tissue damage. But UV, if the more red shifted light would be more easier to have the in the use. So they can emit the light and can basically damage the that particular tumor. So this compound can be, this type of compound can be used in the photodynamic therapy. Next, please. So also the lifetime, also that how the basically stability of the transition state. This is the graph that how to do the photophysiology, and depending on the substituent, on the bezo group, that how the they attenuate the electronic property, they also attenuate the absorption property as well as the fluorescence property of the molecules. Next, please. So now my another student is this, the density functional theory. Density functional theory basically is theoretical computational chemistry. They use the some kind of the software, and they use their x, y, z coordinate, and optimize the geometry. Optimization means the lowest energy configuration, lowest energy, how the molecules, how the atoms can be arranged in a molecule with the lowest energy state, with the ground state, that is the. So she basically took this kind of molecule and that told that these are the most stable ground state structure of the phosphorus molecule. So, but this study is very, very helpful in to analyze the UV spectroscopy, because according to UV, the homoluminal gap, you know, the homoluminal, homo means highest occupied molecular orbital and luo means lowest unoccupied molecular orbital. This basically this electron withdrawing and electron releasing group, they basically attenuate this gap. If the electron withdrawing there, they can increase or decrease. Electron releasing, they can also increase. So depending on the substituent, on the major position, they can basically decrease the homologue gap or increase the homologue gap. So this study can help in understanding the UV electronic spectroscopy of a molecule, that how the molecules behave, where the more electron density is there. By looking. Next, please. Okay, next. Leave it. So what I told, that depending on the substituent present on the meso group, you can basically see the how the basically homologue gap, this is the in electron volt, this is the homologue gap, and this is basically vary with the presence of the electronic group or electron releasing group on the meso carbons and the beta hydrogen. Next, please. That I told you, that this is the final, basically after analyzing the your molecule with the UV spectroscopy, you are using NMR spectroscopy, your Mars spectroscopy, fluorescence, you can finally find out the structure of the molecule by using the X-ray crystallography. And X-ray crystallography basically received 2 Nobel Prize in chemistry in 2010 from Ada Nathan from the Israel, from Weizmann Institute of Science, with the our Venkatraman from the our Indian from the UK. They received both the same in 2010 with the crystallography. They basically solved the crystals of the ribosome. So this is the structure, that how the basically atoms are arranged, especially arrangement of atoms in a three-dimensional structure. So you can find out that now everything can be correlated with the, now you have the NMR, you can easily say that my NMR is due to this, because this and so many hydrogen bonding interaction, how the hydrogen bonding, basically hydrogen bonding is very important in cold kind of molecules. Next, please. Next. Okay. Now come to the application of phosphorus. This phosphorus corals can be basically can be applied in microorganism inactivations, anti-cancer activities, nitrate sensing, and bioimaging, and foster energy resonance transfer. That is the recent, this is called FERAFRAT. You can use it here. Next, please. Now come to the cobalt coral, and cobalt coral basically is very, very important molecule. Next. Yes. Oh, go back, please. Little go back. Yeah. That we have discussed that you can use a cobalt coral, and you have the phosphorus coral, the fluorescence. I told you that about the NMR spectroscopy. The NMR spectroscopy can be used to find out the number of hydrogen atoms. Now, the fluorine NMR can also be done with the, if you have the fluorine in the molecule, like CF3, you have the difluoro, you have the pentafluoro. This fluorine NMR, you can get the peak of fluorine by using the 19 fluoroisotope in the NMR spectroscopy, and you can have the, this is the ortho, meta, and para. The three in the, this is the ortho, meta, and para. You can use the different kind of the signal you can get in the fluorine molecule. Next, please. Next. Okay. This is cobalt coral. The synthesis is same for the free base. Cobalt synthesis is also same. You can use the metal acetate, you can take the metal acetate in DMF, and finally evaporating, you can find out the metal complex. And but the most important in the coordination chemistry, the how to use these kind of molecule. Like you have, we have the manganese for the oxygen catalysis. You can have the phosphorus for so many imagings. And now the cobalt. Cobalt is one of the important metal, and now is for the electrocatalysis. Electrocatalysis is very important nowadays, because the this you can use for the hydrogen evolution reaction, you can use the oxygen reduction, you can use for the water splitting nowadays. So we have used here the cobalt coral in anion sensing. This cobalt coral was more sensitive towards the cyanide, fluoride, and acetate. And this we have used this molecule, and with the fluoride, acetate, and cyanide, this shows the brown color, rest is the same in green color. This can be the anion sensing. We have also used the fluoride sensing, but I am not saying here the fluoride sensing, this one. And this cobalt coral was basically also used for the hydrogen fashion in our lab. We had the hydrogen revolution, where we have taken this complex, this pentaquadrant complex, and this has been used for the hydrogen evolution reactions also. That because if you record the cyclic voltammeter, the second reduction is -1.1, so this is near to the hydrogen. So it can basically you can take the cobalt 3, and it can also basically easy evolve the hydrogen, and that hydrogen is used for any kind of system. So nowadays the more research is focused on these kind of the basically different kind of energy resources, that how the basically we can take the hydrogen, how we can split the water in oxygen, hydrogen, so that can be used for the energy purpose, different kind of energy purpose. The more research is nowadays is basically this is the more prominent and more emergent area. Now come to this is the different kind of, now we have discussed the porphyrin, we have taken the coral. Now this is the most important what I started my basically research career in DTU from this molecule in 2010, and this is called carboporphyrin system, that is called benzy porphyrdimethyl. Means we have the three pyrrole system here, three pyrrole, but this is the N-confused, this is also basically carbon system. Next, please. Yeah. Now this is the meta-benzy porphyrin system. You can say that we have three pyrrole system and one basically here the different flannel ring with the two. Here you have the conjugation, but if we don't have, this is sp2 hybrid carbon. This is sp2 hybrid carbon. So it is basically aromatic in nature. But this is called carboporphyrin, or you can benzy porphyrin, because it contains the benzene ring, so it's called benzy porphyrin. But here you have the sp3 hybridized carbon. There's no basically, and sp3 hybrid carbon here, and this is conjugation up to this part only. No, the conjugation is here, written here. There is no conjugation in this particular molecule. Now from here, the conjugation is lost here. So this is called meta-benzy porphyrdimethyl. This molecule is very, very important molecule. Next, please. And this molecule was easily can be synthesized by using simple molecule diol. You can take diol, you can take pyrrole, and you can take any aldehyde. In simple, using the BF3 thread, that is another basically Lewis acid, you can use. All of this kind of molecules are basically acid catalyzed condensation reactions. And you can take the DDQ and you can synthesize this molecule, and that is the pink in color. Basically, this is the pink compound. You can easily see in the column, while doing the column, the pink color would be there, and you can easily synthesize this molecule. But the one of the drawback of this molecule is that it is highly basically susceptible to oxidation. Once you keep it out in the air for longer time, this will oxidize. This compound, this carbon get oxidized, and you have the oxygen here, double bond O, and it becomes gamma lectum ring. Gamma is becomes the lectum, and lectum, it can be oxidized this position, and it can oxidize at this position. So according to the, if this get oxidized from here, it is up, means towards the sp3 carbon. If it is here, it is down, means makes it more far away from this carbon. So this molecule is very important in the, I will tell you in the next, please. So next, please. This is synthesis, no need to tell. And you can see that if you record its UV spectroscopy, the UV spectroscopy is that you can see that this is the solid band. We call it solid band, but it's not actual solid band here. The solid band, it is comes around 350 to 370, and sharp Q bands. You can see this is the high absorbance in the visible region here. And if you metallate it, next please. Yeah, if you metallate this compound, you will see the very, very sharp band, and shifted towards the more red side here. The red side shift is more important for us to have the more biological activity. Next, please. And this molecule can be basically, this is the crystal structure that we have also finalized this molecule by using the extractography, that this whether our compound is actually the sp3 hybrid carbon, and we finally did all this is sp3 carbon, and later one this is another student that she is from only from bsc from Deshbandhu, and she also working with Umesh, and she did all kind of VFT calculations. She was very very good in computational chemistry, so she completed PhD in computational chemistry only. She took this molecule and find out the different kind of hydrogen bonding interaction by using different kind of how the molecule are getting stabilized by the hydrogen bonding. So hydrogen bonding is very important in stabilizing compounds. Very important. In all kind of balanced system, only the hydrogen bonding and van der Waals forces are playing an important role in stabilizing the system. Next, please. So whatever I told you, that this compound is more susceptible to oxidation. It can oxidize here, O up and O down. Next, please. So what she did, she have taken the different kind of compound and replaced this HN with the different kind of the atom. And by using different kind of atom, she optimized the structure by the lowest energy structure by using the Gaussian software, that is the Gaussian zero window software. And she found that the more is the hydrogen bonding, the more the stable compound. And later we identified by using the synthesis that whatever she reported, that whether it can be actually in the synthetic protocol or not, then we synthesize those compound and they are perfectly stable compound. So this she used different kind of most stable forms she found it. Next. And all the things you can see that this basically the stability is basically more due to the hydrogen interaction. Next, please. Next. Okay. So this compound is very very important. I told that this compound only coordinate with the D10 metal. D10 means zinc, cadmium, mercury. Only this compound only coordinate with the zinc, cadmium, mercury, and when it bind with the zinc in a free base form, it without metal ion, it is non fluorescent in nature. If you take the compound dissolved in the dichloromethane, keep it in the UV light, it's non fluorescent. But if you take this compound, add zinc, cadmium, mercury, immediately you will see the red fluorescent. But it is switch on and off system. Without metal, it is switch off. With metal, it is switch on. So switch on off system. So what we did, we thought of using this compound in basically, apoptosis. Apoptosis basically the where the cells are degrading and releasing the zinc metal ion from the cell. So this compound basically bind with the zinc metal, cadmium metal, and mercury metal. Zinc, the stability constant of the zinc is very very high. So it means it can easily bind to the zinc. So what we did, we took the cell and we just added the zinc into the cell. When will we added? And we added our compound and washed the with the some buffer, and we took the confocal microscopy. You can see that the zinc, according to the concentration of zinc, this can be imaged easily. So you can find out where the zinc is available in the cell. It means you can find out the cell basically death apoptosis. You can find out in the cell that how the basically apoptosis take place in the cell by releasing the zinc. So this compound can be used in zinc. So we have used the MDMB-460 cell, is the cancer cell, breast cancer cell, and 468. And another cell we have used, my student used this cell, and they can be imaged easily. Next, please. So being in the Department of Applied Chemistry, we are running the BTech Chemical Engineering and the Polymer Technology. So what we thought that whether we can use this compound, because this compound can sense zinc, cadmium, mercury. So whether we can use our applied chemistry BTech student to involve in this kind of projects, what we have done, we have taken the hydrogel. You know, hydrogel basically is a three-dimensional network of polymeric system. We have taken the hydrogel, we have taken the CMG, carboxymethyl groguam, and then this is the basically initiator, and this is the acrylamide. We have taken the hydrogel, we have added a compound in situ, and this gate after the curing, this after the stirring on the water bath for some time, you can see that this hydrogel become. Hydrogel means basically the polymer with a soft, hard material, but hydrogel is a basically soft material. Then what we did, we added our compound in this one. And our compounds, so if you take without our compound, this is colorless. Hydrogel like polymer is colorless, but if you take our compound, this becomes red. It means our compound perfectly impregnated in the hydrogel matrix, and after that we cut down into the pieces, dry it, and we have used so many studies. That is different story. Now this is the, you can see that this is actual hydrogel. She had taken the picture, and this is the how the our compound engulf in the polymeric matrix. You can see that this is the glucose, this is the basically carboxymethyl guar gum. You know guar gum, you know, guar gum. ग्वार की फली जाते हैं सब वही ग्वार का मिर्ची से निकाला जाता है ठीक है. एंड दिस इज द मोलिक्यूल आवर एनग्राफ इन दिस मोलिक्यूल एंड दिस इज द रेड कलर यू कैन सी वंस यू टेक द जिंक कैडमियम मर्करी इट इमीडिएटली बिकम्स द ग्रीनिश कलर एंड डिपेंडिंग ऑन द टाइम्स यू कैन साइन दिस इज द नेकेड आई डिटेक्शन यू कैन सी यू जस्ट टेक द कंपाउंड आवर हाइड्रोजेल विद आवर कंपाउंड रेड कलर डीप इन टू द कंटेंट इन द सोल्यूशन जिंक कैडमियम मर्करी इमीडिएटली यू विल सी दिस कलर. सो दिस इज द नेकेड आई डिटेक्शन एंड नेक्स्ट स्लाइड प्लीज. So this is the system that you can see that is the on-off, switch on-off system. This is the free base without metal. Once add metal, light, you can see the red color. This is the metal, this is the metallic color. Green color is the metallic color, when the metal, but when you light and light the system, it will become the red color. So this is basically the switch on-off system. And next, please. So this is what exactly we are doing in the research. And I think last part is more important, but this is the, I should acknowledge my research group that this is R.K. Sharma, that Ravi Kumar Sharma, he's the first student and he started this benzene profiling work. Now he's in company. Om Prakash Yadav, he's in the Venkatesh College. And he was my second student, PhD student. Dr. Usura, she is in Polytechnic, Pusa Polytechnic. Dr. Diti Chauhan, she is assistant professor in Broad College. UP Higher Education Commission. Dipali Wale, she is the student of this college only, and now she is in Jaipur. Sikha Rana, she is patent officer. She also developed this benzene. Atul Varsha, she did the oxidation catalysis by using manganese coal. She is a teacher in Aligarh. Ritya Gubba, she recently finished PhD on phosphorus coal. Dr. Jyoti, she recently finished in cobalt coal. And recently, the Indu, Saurav, and Priyanka Yadav are currently working with me, and now she has left to Technion because she is my where my collaborator is in Technion. So he's doing PhD there with me and Professor Gross. And last, thank you for the organizer for inviting me and giving opportunity to deliver this talk. Thank you. If you have any question, you can ask me. I don't know whether you have, but BSc student must understand the this porphyrin molecule because that is, they will must read in the bioinorganic chemistry in third year, I think in third year only. I don't know whether this, I think in 12th also now this chapter bioinorganic chemistry there. But porphyrin basically, one important, and hemoglobin, all of know that that is the basically the similar kind of molecules here. And if you have any question, please welcome. No more questions? It, yeah, please, you can, please. Ah, okay. What I just benzene porphyrin, I mean, they are not that much stable, actually. Once you have to do column in a single day. If you keep it in the column for longer time, because silica can, because silica contains acidic nature, it can also oxidize. So you have to do the fast column and immediately store in the fridge. For metal complex, once it get metal, metallated, it's not that much.
But you use for cell imaging.
Yeah, you can use it for cell imaging. Yeah, that is. Yeah, it's that for that. But if you keep it in the silica and keep it in the more time in the air, it will get oxidized. More time in the air.
So that's what I'm asking.
Yeah.
The air is everywhere.
No, air is everywhere, but the time frame is there. You have to, yeah. You have to store the compound in a vacuum. You can take, you can add the nitrogen and you can flush and tightly bound in the desiccator. Then it is stable for that time. But imaging study is not for the longer time. Once they add it, they take the image. But if the one of the important is that if you have the acidic condition, that immediately get oxidized. That is the more prominent, basically, instability of nature.
And you use one hydrogen also.
Yeah, hydrogen.
Okay.
Because carboxymethyl guar gum basically the more towards the balancing system, because rest is the hydrogel basically using the carboxymethyl is basically biomolecule basically. So that's the more basic intuition toward that we should use the biomolecules for this kind of system.
Is it non-hydrogen?
Yeah, it is non-hydrogen. But methyl guar gum is basically originally available, but the carboxymethyl is the derivative of guar gum. Guar gum is basically available, abundant available. Yeah, come on. You can take it. Yes.
So can we understand mass spectroscopy without the sensor?